Are you ready? It's Friday night, AEW Dynamite's on. SmackDown's over. Monetize this 5 weeks ago, move to Saturday nights. And tonight, it's Friday night throwdown. It's cowboy shit time, huh? We'll find out. What's up, everybody? We're getting ready for the big one. Let's go!
I am cold like December snow. I have carved out this soul made of stone. And now we'll drag you down and sail you out. Embraced by the darkness, I'm losing the light. Encircled by demons, I fight. What have I become? Now that I've betrayed all the lesbians and guys used to call them gay.
It's Pride Month, baby! Happy Pride Month!
I got a rainbow up my ass! Homophobe in mind!
That's fucking weird. I don't know what we're doing. What's up, everybody?
I think it was like mic checking.
Oh, we got the Nasty Boys on the line tonight. We got Jesse J and Garguts trying to suck each other off in the chat.
Yeah.
It happens.
You gonna taste that dick, son?
Ooh. Yeah. Hope it tastes fucking sour.
What do you think about Judas there, Jesse? You think Jericho wrote a piece of shit song, or you think it's amazing? What do you think?
It's not bad. It's just he's like kind of generic rock, though. It's not any, but it's not bad by any means.
But like, for him, it's like it's like amazing that it's him to me. Like otherwise, like if that was just a regular. But what do you think?
I think you're right. That's a great point. Yeah, if it wasn't Chris Jericho, I wouldn't care. But like it wouldn't be. But because it's him, I'm like fuck yeah, dude.
Yeah, I think Judas is probably the best one anyway, though. Like, that's probably their best song.
I like it.
I mean, I don't know. Do you think when he wrote it, he's like, oh, my God, I got a new entrance song. Like, it's so good, it's going to be my entrance song.
Oh, I mean, does he use it for his entrance? Oh, shit.
Oh, my God, you've dropped off the face of the earth.
Oh, shit.
I don't fucking... Dude, I haven't watched one single second of A&W. I almost said A&W, like the root beer. I haven't watched a single second of it. I mean,
oh my God! But I mean,
you think he wrote it?
Jesus, man! Let me.
You think he wrote it when he left WWE? I think he wrote it when he left WWE.
Like Judas, like
everything.
Well, it's a smart move though to use your own shit. You don't.
It's
have
like just listen to the lyrics and then think about it.
Oh yeah, I didn't think about that. That's interesting. I didn't think about that. You know, it's the weird thing about it is like, I mean, Jesse. You know, he's been coming out to it for almost four years now. You know, because
what
he started,
in WWE too.
No, he started coming out to it in New Japan when he had all those big matches with Kenny Omega.
Oh, see, I don't watch that, and I don't watch, dude, I don't watch wrestling.
Wow, I'm blown away by this.
I only have the network so I can watch old shit. That's all I use it for.
And now you really can't find almost anything, in my opinion, on there.
Nah, they took away so much shit. I'm pissed, because, I mean, they had fucking ECW TV, they had Memphis shit, they had Mid-South, they had all kinds of shit. Where is all that?
Not on YouTube.
They can't even get a lot of the main stuff they can't even get on the Peacock. So the WWE Network went from this gigantic library vault to like only 20% of what it was now.
They were probably the greatest they'd gotten to, like, because WWE Network needed work all along, but like it was like the best it had been, and then they got rid of it.
It's kind of funny. What goes up must come way down. I mean, talk about entropy on the fucking network.
Well, I don't see why they must be picking a lot of shit out that Peacock had trouble with, because the day after WrestleMania, or at least like a few couple days, let's say, they had everything up there again. Like that, they had literally no pay per views. They had no raw. They had like nothing on there. And then after Mania, they moved so much shit over there. I was like, what's keeping them from doing all the other shit? It's got to be because they're going to take it. People were saying they were even going to take out DX and like suck it and all that. It's like, no, they're not. They didn't.
They better not. What's up, Steve Kalan? How you doing?
You know.
Hey, Jesse.
That's a Chris Benoit matches.
Did we like coordinate shaving our faces? Like, what's going on here?
Probably. I didn't plan this, but it happened.
Very strange, the two of us.
Dude, our fucking like souls make, like, they fuck each other constantly. Mm. This is just,
you know what?
One, another thing.
I'm a big fan of that singer, that girl, that singer, Meg Myers. Big fan of her. In the last 4 years, she's kind of like gotten a little wacky, and her speaking on her Patreon now is like she starts talking about like stuff that we talk about, like that we're more than we realize, and we're all becoming one, and there's this an awakening going on, and you know, she talked about the vibrations, and I'm like, wow, she had all the bowls, Jesse, all the sound bowls around her, and she was doing that. She goes, I just got into this because she was trying to like talk, trying to like hum and chant at the same frequency as the,
yeah,
it was crazy.
Like, she says she's a musician, right? Like, if you already do music, you're already tapped into it. You just, when you start learning frequencies, though, and you realize you can take your music to a whole nother level where it can connect with people and do more for you and for other people, it's fucking badass. I like tuning to like 432 hertz, for instance, playing like the bass or guitar or whatever. It's just, it's, if you're going to play to other shit or play with people, it's, you know, it doesn't usually work out unless they're all going to tune down to your shit. But it's fun to do the frequencies. Like, I used to take my guitar tuner, I used to check the bowls, and it was great because you'd put it to 432 hertz and you'd ring a bowl and it'd be dead on, dude. Like, better than the instruments that I've, you know, tuned up. I'm like, man, that shit is pure. Like, it's just, it, so when you get like a pure wave of sound, I mean, it's just, it's the shit, man.
Of course, yeah. We got a shout out tomorrow night. Obviously, Monetize This. I know that we've been moved for 5 weeks now to a new night with Monetize This, but every once in a while, I see another person who's like, "Oh, I didn't know you guys moved," and I'm like, "Yeah, we moved to a different night. It's a fake great one because it doesn't have the thing." But this is a pretty good match. The crowd's responding pretty well to this main event right now, better than I thought they would. That's not really the great one, D-Well. She's at it. He got a check mark, bro.
Man, I forget AEW's still going on. Shit.
Yeah, it's still on for another 3 minutes here. We're at the very end. And I'd also want to plug last Monetize This last Saturday. Monetize This is tomorrow night, Saturday night, guys. Remember that. And, of course, Devicius is the king of the week, and he still remains king. Shout out to Devicius. And now... Oh, they're yelling at Brian Cage. Here it comes. He's finally going to turn, it looks like. Stark has the bad neck, but Brian Cage is pacing after him and going after him. He's got the bad neck, though. And now they're out of the ring, leaving Hobbs all by himself. So it looks like the Dark Order is going to pick up some kind of win. Scissor kick misses off the rope. And a spine buster by Hobbs. I'm sorry. I'm thinking I'm at fucking pins again tonight. By the way, to the guys that came up to me tonight, thank you for saying hi. It was fun. Nice people that I met tonight, and that people really... One guy mentioned he likes you, Jesse. He likes your sick humor.
Oh, good.
That's what he said. He said, I like that Jesse guy. He seems perverted. That's what he said to me.
Oh, shit.
Oh, that's just... That was a nice... That was how nice of him.
Yeah, he was so nice. He was like, yo, that Jesse guy you got on your show is like, he's like a weirdo. I feel like he's like a hidden pervert or something. I'm like, well, it ain't hidden.
Hidden?
Yeah, it ain't hidden.
Yeah, what?
I said, he also drops too many, he also, you know, he unfortunately says N-bombs sometimes. We have to fire him. And the guy was like, oh, yeah, but he can say that because.
See?
So a black man tonight. That we don't know, really, but watches the show that I met tonight, that was a fan of the show, said you can say that, but don't say that. Still don't say
it. I know. I love that he gets it, though. Shit. I mean,
yeah,
I say it was funny.
Jesse's usually. Yeah, he was.
Then they said,
whoa.
They said, how much to kill?
How much to kill who?
And they said, how much for the Mexican? How much to kill?
How
Jesse?
Much to kill?
No, yeah. Then they
fucking
said how much
free,
to kill?
Free.
How much to kill Drew? That's what they said next.
Oh.
Dark Order gets
then
the
they
big
said
win.
How much for the Mexican to do my lawn?
Oh man.
I wouldn't trust you with a fucking lawnmower. I know the stereotype doesn't fit with you.
Yeah, based on your
you
quality.
Halfway through and go get make food and shit.
They'd have to. You'd have to pay them to mow their lawn. You'd have to pay them.
Yeah, I'll mow their lawn in five minutes, dude. Tops.
All right. Yeah, like CG, yeah, exactly. That was fucking corner house I had. That thing was a pain in the ass. All uneven and shit.
Hey, the little guy's there.
Ugh. Oh, where it's like slopes.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, bitch, bro. Dude. Negative one.
It's a big beer bath tonight on AEW to celebrate here at the end. Damn.
And it's not live. Do you realize that?
Yeah, it's taped this week. Yeah, last week was the last live night. You're right. It's a good point. So there you go. I mean,
did that ruin it for you at all? I mean, or...
no, I just didn't see anybody posted anything about like who won.
Oh, got it.
Yeah, I'm surprised
they already
fucking
knew.
They weren't. Well, there's no major. What it is you know, what it is. There's no major spoilers. You know it. That's almost a spoiler, because you know it's like, yeah. Well, if they're not posting any spoilers, there's nothing to spoil. You know, it's just a whatever. If you want to look
which
them
is
up,
cool. I think as long as it doesn't ruin the experience of watching it for you, I say fuck it.
Yeah,
fuck it.
No, what's up, man? Now it's Friday night throwdown time. As we have a good time tonight, you can talk wrestling. You can talk about whatever you want in the chat tonight. I don't give a shit. If you want to get fucking weird with me, get weird with
sex.
Me. We'll talk about sex all night long. Tomorrow night is monetize this, so save up the alcohol, save your liver, save everything for tomorrow. Unless, of course, people start losing their minds tonight and try to kill me with alcohol. I mean, that's...
Dunkachino?
Don't their
mind
fault.
If I do.
What's my name?
Dunkachino.
It's a whole new game.
Dunkachino.
You want creamy goodness? I'm your friend. Say hello to my chocolate blend.
I'm smoking on wedding cake and Gorilla Glue for your show.
Oh.
Mm. Nice. Good mix. Good
smoking
mix.
On wedding cake in Gorilla Glue. That's bro, fucking weird.
I kind of have the same shit over here, pretty much. I mean, I never know which ones are crossed
bro,
with which.
I got that
I know
shit
that
right here. What the
same
fuck?
One.
I legitimately
what?
Got that.
Wait a minute. This guy says this, and then you guys are like, yeah, we got that shit right here. What the fuck
yeah.
is... What the hell
I know, right? Well, I mean, I know that those are the... That's two of the four that my buddy crosses between them all, so I know I have a mix of some form of the two he just mentioned.
What the hell are you guys doing? Well, like, what is everybody doing?
I don't know,
like,
man.
Gorilla glue and every. Oh,
I've
I'm
been
doing
so like on point with shit lately. I don't trust it. Like it's scaring me. Like usually I'm on board. I'm like, oh shit. Like I'm just it's been too long. I'm not used to that. Too many things lining up.
Wait, you're on board with doing Gorilla Glue?
Oh shit, dude. Gorilla Glue. Just gorillas. Anything.
Oh.
You sniff it.
You don't want to do the gorillas, bro. You'll get that COVID or pass it on or whatever the hell.
What?
I'll just, I don't know, Gorilla Glue my hand to my dick. I mean, it'll be a, might as well. It's there all the time anyway. Right? Yeah. Right. Where
sex.
The fuck is Luke?
There's
speaking
the sex
of fucking
part
dicks.
Right there.
Oh, Luke Rojas? He's probably being raped by his family right now.
He's probably being raped by that damn statue that stares at him in his fucking basement.
He's probably trying to figure out how to kill or whatever he
is. Oh, shit.
Yeah, he's probably got plans in the works. Psycho.
Make him look like a deer. He'll do it himself.
That's a good point. That's a good point, man. It's a great point. Let's go to another dono, I guess. There's more coming in here.
Shit bomb!
You become a shit bomb. Furry balls.
Cho, I actually subscribed last night to Impact Plus, and next is your Patreon. Impact has been good, and I don't feel like I've gotten screwed over.
Well, that's good to hear, but I mean, how dare you give Impact money before me? No, I'm just kidding. Furry Balls plopped menacingly on the table. He's actually been donating every show. Thank you, Furry Balls. And yeah, you become a patron. We'll love you for it, no doubt about it. Look at that, giving money to Impact and to my show. Both two pathetic shows. I mean, what can you say? But no, no.
Yeah, but one is successful.
That's... Well, you know what's funny about that is, like, Impact followed the success, right? So think about this. Think about this. Back when Brother Nero and all that stuff happened and it stopped, I was getting 1.2 million views a month. So
on your TNA stuff or just in general?
No, just in general a month. I was getting 1.2 million views. So it's at one point, we were actually beating Impact Wrestling, right?
Wow.
So we were beating Impact Wrestling. Now, Impact Wrestling gets about 80,000 views, right? Or something like that. I think that's what it is. And I'm getting about somewhere around 380,000 views. So, like, we're always racing to beat Impact here at the show as far as views go.
Well, the thing about Impact was, you know, Dixie Carter was fucking everybody in the back, so.
You had to move up from beating that Johnny guy.
Bend over. I mean.
Yeah, go bend
get
over.
Get more views.
That's just kind of funny how that works. AEW was nice, I think, tonight. Nice
well, you're
enough.
Consistent as fuck, too, though. That's kind of kept, I mean, I'm surprised you've not missed that many shows over the years. Like, you really don't miss them, and that's, I think that helps a shit ton.
Missed five Raws, I think, like, or something.
Yeah, because a lot of people miss shows, yeah. or they quit altogether, or they move their shit somewhere. Like, you've just steady fucking gone forward. No, even if the product was like, you want to kill yourself, you know, like, watch yeah. it. Like, you still True. Stuck it through, you know.
There are times where you did fall asleep.
Well, that's gonna, show yeah, up. Well, that's why we got, that's why Jake's there. Fucking A.
Yeah, that's why Jake's
there. Yeah, those five times.
You don't throw up, get high, and do the best review ever.
Well, even when he said tonight, he's like, oh, I'm not going to be there tonight because I'm doing something.
Oh.
I was like, oh, no, because I knew I was out at wrestling. Yeah. And for the people that don't know, I was calling wrestling tonight in Kingston, Mass. And so, and you know what was really fun to be out there wrestling tonight was, it was weird to see, I didn't know they were going to do this, actually, but it was weird to see them, they used my promo, like the promo video I built up for Teddy Goods and JT Dunn. They used that and played it live at the place. And so, like, it was weird. I was listening to everyone react to the video package and stuff, and I think it went really well. People clapped at the end of it. I was like, what the hell? That was cool. Like, they were ready for the show, like, after that. And then, you know, so that was cool. But my voice is, like, pretty fucked up from screaming. And it was funny because I kept yelling. Dude, at one point it was too quiet. Like, the second half of the show, the world title match, it got kind of quiet, and the match before that was really not very well done, I guess. And the people just died. And I was, like, yelling at certain parts because there was certain amazing little things that happened, and I'm, like, yelling. And this guy, some of the people in the front row just kept turning around and looking at me like, what the fuck? But it's like, well, what do you want me to do, not call it because everybody's quiet? You know what I mean? Like, I was really loud, though. People could hear me. It was funny. But it's too bad. Not as big a crowd as last time. But, you know, at the bowling alley. And all I could think about was how I wanted to bowl, too. I was like, oh, man, I want to go bowling.
I'm Sucked. Surprised there wasn't a spot where somebody fucking bowled, you know, while in a match.
Last time they did that, I think. I think they really did do that last time. I think somebody threw a ball at somebody or something. I don't know. I don't remember now, but pretty sure that something like that happened. But yeah, AEW did all right for being taped. I mean, from what I could see, I didn't see it all, though. I started watching when I got home, or when I started driving home on YouTube TV in my car. So I was like, you know, I probably saw, you know, trying to listen to it while driving without being able to see it since about 10:20, you know, until about 11:30 when I got home, or 11:20 when I got home. So it was kind of rough to try to keep track of what really was happening on AEW for me. And, you know, SmackDown I ended up not being able to see at all because of...
Nobody else did.
Well,
don't worry, nobody
yeah, it's too bad I didn't. I wish I could. Well, the other thing about it, too, was I didn't... Again, I don't really... I didn't see AEW enough to give it a good judgment. I don't know. I got to watch it again later. But also, like I said, I don't know, man. I was just... no video footage. You take Cronin at all? What are you talking about? What do you mean, Bearsy? I took some. Yeah.
Yeah. If you had
I tweeted it out. I think some of it, but there's some other footage that was cool. Yeah. There's some. Here's some footage of it. Oh yeah. Here's some footage. Yeah. I was watching it and I thought it was interesting. Because it was weird. Because I didn't know they were gonna use the promo that I made for fun. You know. JT Dunn looked great.
He's been angry at Kenny Goods for a long time.
I was trying to write something down while I was doing it. But it was a good time. Had a fun time at Pins. Shout out to the couple of people that came up and said hi. I don't think they... had as big of a crowd as they had the last time. I don't know what the hell JT Dunn was doing at Pins at 8 hours, like, before the show. Guy was in the parking lot at, like, 3 p.m., like, oh, I'm here, where are you? What the hell were you doing there at 3 p.m.? Fuck that. Yo, Nikki J, the weed god, is here. What's up, brother?
What's up, dude? What's
you want to get wet?
What's up, car guys? What's up, Jesse?
Yo.
What's up, brother?
How you doing, dude?
You sleepy? Good. Sleepy? You awake?
Yeah. Right. A game released at 12 o'clock, and I'm just downloading it quick.
What game?
It's called Arms Gates of Hell Ostfront. It's a World War II game. It's kind of like a strategy game in a way.
I would love to go back to World War II and just stare at people whose arms are blown off. Yeah. I'm sorry.
Holy shit.
No, yeah. You don't think it'd be funny? Come on.
Why is there a fucking black dynamite?
There's a lot of other things I'd like to see during World War II. That'd be cool.
What's that, like rape a French girl?
No, the fucking aircraft that they're coming up with, all the different tanks. I mean, the secret Nazi shit.
Yeah, that would be really cool to find out what kind of Nazi shit they were, you know, finding out about and whatever.
By the way, just quick, I watched SmackDown and AEW.
Really?
I fell asleep for an hour during SmackDown and was pretty impressed with AEW for a taping. It was pretty good.
Wow, really? For a taping? Okay. And SmackDown was not good. That's weird. Good. Usually SmackDown's all right. They weren't good.
Dude, the three-way between Roman and the Usos is just dumb. Like, it's just, this is just another thing that they suck with storylines at WWE. Like, they just really do. Like, they're just horrible. It's cringe.
Well, yeah. But, well, it's good to know that, you know, tomorrow night I'll monetize this. Davicius crown is on the line, and my belt is not on the line, so take that, motherfucker. Robin Banks says, dude, he says he'd fuck a Nazi chick is what he said. Jesus. That's weird.
Yeah, but I'm not into shaved head girls, though, even though, I don't know.
Yeah. Yeah, it's one of those things.
Some say your shaved girls are cool or sexy, man. Come on. Hello.
Yeah, like one of those G.I. Jane. What about
that Thug Rose that fought a couple weeks ago? Remember her? The shaved head?
Well, not memorable.
I thought you knew everything.
Nope. You know, I was thinking more like Demi Moore when she shaved her head.
Oh, yeah, for G.I. Jane.
She's got a big ass.
Yeah, that's exactly why I said G.I. Jane. I was thinking of her shaved fucking head in that movie. That was a crazy movie. I remember seeing that in the theater.
That broke down the barriers.
I wanted to see her, obviously you didn't want to see her, like, raped or whatever, you know, if you're not a psycho. But what I was hoping was that she would get, and I know that you don't want to do this because you don't want to make it some stereotype that girls are, I'm just some girl looking for sex. You know, you want to make her tough and gritty and stuff. But I really wish there was a scene where she just got railroaded, or maybe she could have done the railroading. I don't care. But I wanted to see her naked.
Like the general's daughter?
Yeah, like I wanted to see. Holy shit, dude! I wanted to see like a load on her shit on her head. That's what I'm saying. Like a load on her fucking head. Indiana Jones fucked a Nazi. That's right. Joseph Ross, Indiana Jones fucked a Nazi. That's a great point.
And smoking on the ashes of dead back wets in their parents' tears, which smells like hot sauce, and him buying a 18-wheeler to smuggling illegals across the border. Oh, Speedy Gonzalez got ate by a snake.
Oh, you've got to be kidding me.
I wonder if they got a mod for that on American Truck Simulator yet.
Why does it get really weird on there?
No, I meant like if there's a mod where you can like pick up like illegals like in Mexico and like bring them over the border.
That'd be a fuck a mod. That should be a game. That should be called like Over the Border or something like that. Oh, no. Fuck over it. It's like, no, it's like Crazy Taxi called Crazy Border. Oh, my God.
Border.
What a great idea.
Either slingshot them over, have them dig in a tunnel.
Maybe got to smuggle them anymore.
You got to get
them. The game's over already. You don't even got to smuggle them. You just fucking throw them over the fucking thing, and they're already legal.
Can you imagine? Like, oh, God, dude. It's all kinds of things. It would be like GTA, or that should be a mode in GTA. It's like you got to worry about the cartels. You got to try to make sure the kids stay alive. That's crazy. Aruby, thanks for subbing to the channel. You gotta make sure the kids are alive.
Get saved by Biden.
Yeah, well, no, Biden will never come to see the border, so it's okay. You will never see him in the game. It won't be
See the border, then that acknowledges that there's a problem. Yeah, there's a fucking problem. You shut down half the shit that's going on.
Your free lives is just fucking Biden's face.
You ever seen?
Yeah, and you told the whole fucking Southern Hemisphere for a year and a half that you would accept them in, and now you're telling them no.
Right. Yeah, dude. That's what's weird. Like, and not to go political, but they did this. They said, "Come to the country." How dare anyone say they shouldn't come? Come here, bring everybody. And when the caravan was coming, they were like, "Come on in." They were like, "Come on in. Go look it up. Anybody." And it's like now they're here, and they're like, "Don't come in." Like, wait a minute.
Right.
Like, dude, what the fuck? Like, so weird. It was like when, it's kind of like in the Capitol when Trump had to go on the air finally, like 10 years later, and he was like, "Go home, don't," like he finally said go home. It was like this, it's not even that bad because this has been a year and a half building. This has been a year and a half of come to the country, gather it all, we'll let you in. We'll let you in. Oh wait, we won't. Don't come. Which is fucking hilarious. Like don't come.
And, and she's still getting harassed by like the media down there too, asking her, like she was asked today by a Mexican reporter, like in the newsroom, like, "Are you going to the, you know, Mexico, United States border?" And she laughed and she said, "Yes, we will be." And then in the middle of her responding, she cut her off again and asked her when she was going, because she knows she was bloviating talking about going.
Their press is real. Like they're used to our
they don't
press.
Give a fuck.
They're used to our fake press that can't ask any questions, and they're like, "Oh fuck."
The other thing is, did you see how when she first landed, they were protesting her, saying that Trump won, and to go back to the United States, we don't want you here.
Oh wow,
telling you, they had protesters right when she landed outside the airport.
And then they also said, "Give us a taco." They also said that was weird when they said that. I didn't expect that. Listen to this.
"Oh my God, yeah. Oh my God, you're the best. Oh, you're the best. Oh my, oh God, I'm gonna explode.
Do not come.
I don't think I can hold it.
Do not come.
I gotta come. I gotta.
Do not come.
We did.
Oh my God. thank you so much. That was very strange. Very strange. Sorry.
That's a good fucking couple right there.
Here's a couple.
Just imagine right back in that bitch fucking for real though. And she's like in all of his videos fucking promoting his stupid ass fucking protein mix, and he fucking clotheslines her on fire.
Wait, who clotheslined who? Who clotheslined who?
Like if you did that, fucking clothesline that fucking fat bitch, well, it would be funny if you fucking clotheslined her to the pool.
Oh, when Ryback clotheslined that big... Yeah. You like, fucking cut out a million times, so, like, I couldn't understand what the fuck you were saying. That was crazy. Wow, okay. I get it. Yeah, that was fucking hilarious. What a fucking dildo.
What a fucking fair... Oh, that's why. The sensitivity is all the way up. There we go.
Ba-boom,
I got a sensitive dick right now.
What? Clip that.
Fucking high.
Clip that, bro. I got a sensitive dick right now. That's weird. that laugh is weird.
Gargus, come mow my lawn tomorrow so I don't have to.
I got to mow mine, too.
I'll be there in a minute.
Dude, I got to mow my lawn, too.
Dude, I actually don't mind it. I got about four acres to mow, so.
No, I got to mow.
Yeah, like, you know, honestly, I'll probably download this and listen to it again tomorrow. Me, yeah. I got a garden tractor.
Well, see, my problem is that because my fence isn't put up, we can't put up a fence yet until we can be able to do it is, I have to, flatten down the chicken wire. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
And then, push the lawnmower into the front yard. And then, I have to reset up the fucking manual fence all over again just to get it back up again. So it's, a pain in the balls. And I don't want to do it, but I got to do it. So, if I had a fence that just swung open, though, you know what I mean, that I could just swing right open and just, you know, then I would be, I'd be like, oh yeah, fuck, this is easy. Mo, swing the fence open, mo. But now it's like mo and then undo the whole fence and shit like that. It's a pain in the balls. I don't know.
Wait, why the fuck do you have to undo the whole,
because it's like chicken wire and it's like, so the dogs don't get out. So it's like permanently pushed. Yeah. And then, so I basically flatten it and then roll over it. But then in order to get it to go back up straight again, I got to put the poles in. It's not a big deal. It's a fucking, I'm just being lazy. You know, I'm being like, oh, fuck, I got to do that, you know? But it's a hindrance to where, like, I would definitely do it a lot better if there wasn't, you know, if the fucking fence opened up easy or whatever you want to call it. Ryback
just get the weed eater.
Well, there's too much grass. There's a lot of grass. Like, there's, I mean, you know, it takes
you
a little
just, yeah, you just need to fucking take it apart, yeah.
I need a fucking... I need to put up a opening door, you know, that's all. Once you get a door up there.
Well, not that's where you start you got a kid, you could be like, all right, now you help me. Take apart the fence while I mow the grass or at least pick it up.
Well, that's what I want to do to Gavin, just be like, all right, you get the fucking fence down. And then we'll figure it out, you know.
Make him your slave. That's what my fucking parents did every time. They'd be like, yo, you go move all the shit. I'll just fucking go with the weed eater and the shit like that.
Right. Well,
but
we'll
they'd
see.
Be like, all this fucking bullshit in the way. Fucking be a pain in the ass.
You know what I do? I don't even have a string trimmer or a weed whipper. I mix up some Roundup and some other chemicals and just go around and kill the grass where, you know, you'd have to do like, you know, like, you're trimming on the outside, and that way I can just get on my rider and just fucking ride around and not even have to worry about trimming or anything.
Oh, fuck.
Yeah.
Yeah, I always enjoy a nice riding lawnmower, you know. We could probably get one for here, but it'd be like a little overkill. There's no need really for it.
Dude,
like,
you got three kids. If I were you, I'd get three push lawnmowers. Fucking get them out there. Fucking
that's what I'm thinking.
That.
Well, only Gavin. Yeah. I mean, Gavin can do it. I've had him do it. He's done the front. So, but
dude, he fucking had a growth spurt. I saw the picture you posted on Instagram the other, of them in the pool. Yeah. Holy shit!
Yeah,
that
dude,
kid's got tall.
He's really like tall and like he's thick. He's like strong. Like for I don't know how he's strong because he doesn't do anything, but he's strong. He's like like he's Leah. Like he's Leah.
He don't fucking do anything.
You know what I mean? Like, I'm like, how the fuck are you this strong? Like, I'm like wrestling with him and he's like shoving me and I'm like, oh, I got to really shove you. Like, you're really fucking pretty strong, you know? And then it's like, wow, I noticed it. I was like, wow, you're pretty fucking strong. You know, we're wrestling around. He's tough, man. He's got a vertical base. I'm like, you'll be good if you go into wrestling, you'll be good. I was telling him that. I was like, dude, if you can wrestle, like, you'll be good at it. And he's like, oh, okay. He's quiet like Leah. So he's like, okay. I don't know. Like I'm telling you.
Okay.
Quarterback, too. Okay. You can be a quarterback. Oh, donation. It's not playing. Okay, oh, blanked out. I'm going to fuck that Italian midget, JD. Oh, I think he said N-word midget. And feed him to
JD's
his cats.
JD's Italian?
Well, you think he's Sicilian. He's Sicilian or something. Ryback Rapes. That's Ryback Rapes that just donated. Oh, my God. Jesus.
I'm gonna fuck that Italian fucking midget. And then I'm gonna fuck his cats. I'm gonna fuck his cats in Joe's yard. Then give Joe's wife my wiener.
Like the fucking it says wiener, bro.
Oh my god, yeah. Oh my god, you're the best. Oh, you're the best. Oh my god, I'm gonna explode.
Do not come.
I don't think I can hold it.
Do not come.
I gotta come. I gotta.
Do not come. We did it.
Oh.
Do not come. That's fucking hilarious.
Do not come. I'm gonna come. I'm gonna come in your face. Fuck.
That's her special right there.
Hmm.
She tells that to Biden every night. Do not come.
Imagine that.
He's like,
That's crazy.
I can't even do it. Joe Biden fucking coming. That'd be like just dust coming out of his dick.
Yeah, I was going to say just Ugh.
Fucking. Did Xbox release all its stuff the other day yet, or no?
E3's tomorrow. Are you going to be doing anything on that?
Yeah, I'm sure I'll be live for it.
Oh my god. Oh. Can't fucking wait! I'm going to fucking do a hate crime.
Oh, what the fuck?
I got it.
What the fuck? What the fuck, dude?
Did you ever see the picture I sent you the other day in Discord?
Wait a minute. What? Oh my god, I don't even know what to do
Discord
right now.
Go to your Discord and check your DMs quick.
Oh my god.
Promise me?
On Discord?
Yeah, check your DMs quick for me. I celebrated Pride Month.
Oh boy. Would you celebrate it like the Muslims do and you fucking threw a guy off a building? I mean, what's going on here?
Kinda. I guess you could. Yeah.
All he did was.
I don't see a DM from you. On Discord, at least. Maybe I'm crazy.
All he did. Well, just tell him what you did.
I'm trying to see. I don't see it. I don't know why I don't see your. I see Coda. Oh, then now I see it. Okay. Oh god. White pride.
Mm-hmm. Wow.
And you wrote it in like with what?
Yeah, I was power washing the house and kinda got a little carried away writing shit in the concrete.
Yeah, you...
Well, there's nothing you can say white pride. I mean I guess it just means you're not like you don't hate your own culture. You know, it's like black pride, that's okay.
I wrote black pride too.
Oh, let's see. There you go.
Yeah. Well, the same morning I was on the show and he was just like writing shit in the fucking thing. And all of a sudden I see a swastika. And I was like,
Oh my God.
I had to fucking exit out of his fucking thing.
Well, that earned
him.
Yeah,
that was Saturday morning. Yeah.
That earned him the name Nikki Nazi. A lot of people were calling him Nikki Nazi all week because of that. Well, and you know, he was just trying to explain World War II to people. So
World War II is very fascinating. I love it.
Well, we won. We beat the Nazis.
Think about it. I mean, when we went into Europe, D-Day was June 6th, and then a year later in April, the war was over in Europe. I mean, yeah. It took us almost like less than a year, if you will.
I don't know. I mean,
obviously, then we had to go to the Pacific and finish that up.
Finish it.
Finish in my rectal cavity hole.
Oh,
my
yeah.
Corn is there.
You want to
enema? Enema it.
Enema
it with Go pool ahead. Sand.
Enema
pool sand in my rectal area.
Enema me. I'll be your enema me. Enema in me.
Dude, I might smoke. Maybe I'll smoke tonight instead of tomorrow. That way, if I ruin tonight,
do it.
Because if I ruin the show tonight, who cares about tonight's show? As long as monetize, this is okay tomorrow. So tomorrow night, monetize this will be safe. Tomorrow. But tonight, maybe I'll whip out some weed and smoke. I'll get fucking just whip fucking obliterated tonight.
You'll sleep really like a baby.
You'll fucking
freak
out.
After all the fucking panic attacks are tiring.
Maybe I'll have enough of my life.
Wait, you talking about smoking or edible? What are you talking about?
Smoking first, really, but.
Oh, that's probably the way to go, because then you can titrate it and see how you feel as you go before you go any further. You know.
Oh my God, the guys
the
tonight
never yeah. seem to work out.
Stan wrote Johnny Drip Drip in the chat tonight, but there was a tag team tonight at the wrestling show, and they said something about they said that they had unlimited drip. And I said something on commentary, dude. I went, unlimited drip. My doctor told me I had that. I don't know what that means though, or something like. And it was just, I don't know, it was terrible. But dude, it was fucking, it was funny. I don't know, bro. It was funny because I was like, wow, they got to be in the back. Like, what the fuck is he saying? Oh my God, dude.
I swear, do they ever after the show? I know we used to say, dude, what the fuck were you like? Some Mexicans would come out and fucking my friend yeah. Terrell Temple would be going.
No, he was he's always going, like he's like great job. He's always telling me good job, great job. He's probably so busy at looking at everything that he doesn't even realize what I said, you know, but he was like I was like unlimited drip.
Oh. Plus it's pretty loud, so, you know, it's
Was this sold out, Joe?
Probably.
No, it was probably less than I've seen in that place, to be honest. I think it's got to do with the pandemic. Because in Rockland the other night at that show, there was like 200-something people. It was really good. Mm. And tonight it was like there was like 68 people or 75 people or something like that.
Damn.
So, yeah, it was, yeah, I'll smoke weed. Yeah. Oh, D. Welsh is offering to drop bombs. I mean, you should save the bombs for tomorrow, probably.
Yeah, I'd say that shit.
Oh, unless he's got a whole pack of bombs or something.
I don't know. If you want to donate tonight, do it under $5, right? Or something.
I mean, oh, fuck it.
Wait a minute.
Well, I mean, listen, if you want to do it both nights, feel free to do it both nights. Will you do shots if a bomb or two? Yeah, maybe I will. Maybe. I mean,
dude,
you gotta
be
careful.
I've got fucking plenty of whiskey. I'll help you make up for it. So, yeah, if you guys want to go a little crazy, that way Joe doesn't kill himself by himself.
I'll kill myself.
I mean, I'll fucking take
shots.
Yeah,
you got anything?
Or a drink.
Whatever.
Jesse's
I probably
do
shouldn't.
It
I went to the fucking. I went to the fucking chiropractor today. I probably shouldn't. But
I will
whatever.
Smoke as well. I will smoke on cam. I will smoke on cam.
Yeah.
You want to do that?
All right. Smoke it. Hopefully, Leah doesn't flip shit.
That's
no,
a good
she'll
point.
Be fine if he just smokes.
You know
if,
what I'll
if
do
if
is
he does edibles and flips out. That's when she doesn't like it.
I'll let her know. Yeah, you know. I'll let her know. Yeah, save the bombs for tomorrow. But you know what? If you want to throw, if you want
to
throw,
even tell her unless you have to. Like,
if you
want to
throw a couple, if you want to throw a couple my way, feel free to. But if, only if you can't tomorrow. But you know what? Maybe I will. And you know, I think she'll understand if I tell her. If I let her know, give her the heads up, like, hey, I'm gonna be puffing a little bit of this. But there's no, but the heat isn't on, so that's good. That was the problem. When the heat's not on, then it won't carry
the
up.
Heat is on. Sorry.
Yeah, I'll do shots and smoke, D. Welsh. How about that? We'll do that. We'll see
the
that.
Fuck is wrong?
Tomorrow night, Devichus puts his crown on the line.
Deviche, come fun. On down. Or what? What's his name?
Pico said do a bump. If you do.
Oh, I'm going to call him Ceviche. Easier. Do a bump. you that kind of bump. Never mind. I was like, wait a minute, dude. It's going to cost you more than $3 for the bump. Like a little bump. Of, never mind. God damn, that's I get $1.50 worth
I
of
think
cocaine.
He means that. I think that's what he means.
That? No, well, who did the joke? Was it that was Richard Pryor, right? I think it was Richard Pryor. Yeah, I think so. Fuck it, I get a motherfucker coming up for $1.50 cocaine. No. Oh my god, it's the wind to blow the shit away.
I haven't seen Richard Pryor fucking.
Nah, you don't want to go on that.
I haven't seen that shit in a while, though.
We'll smell your dick. How about that? We'll smell your dick, Gargus.
It's good stuff, man. I miss it. Once in a while, I got to go back just to see how we used to talk as people. Like, the shit he says, it takes you back. You almost think it's another fucking planet. It doesn't even seem like it was us.
Thank you, Lightkeeper, for 7. No, it's true, Jesse. It's shocking when you see it. It's shocking. It's like, what?
Absolutely.
Fuck, we can't do this. Like, oh my god, bro.
Shit bomb.
Started the show when you did. We
I'm telling you, Joe, you talk about me one more time. I'm going to fuck all your animals. Then I'm going to feed Leah cum from my pack of feeder cum, feeder cum, feeder cum.
Oh my god, Ryback
that
rapes.
Song like feeder cum, feeder cum, feeder cum.
I'm going to feed a cum, feeder cum, feeder cum. Dude, that's Ryback
like
rapes.
DMX track.
Ryback rapes. You know what, Ryback? You need to shut the hell up, brother, and just keep peddling your shit before I send the great one over to kick you in the dick. Okay? He'll kick you right in your fucking dick. You understand that? Understand it, brother. Understand
it. Does he
have
a dick? I thought he had, like.
Oh, Ryback?
$100.
Oh,
it's donation time.
Oh, shit.
Boy.
That's like 4 shots.
Ask and you shall receive.
Oh. Holy shit. Right. We lost Nikki J, though. I don't know what happened to him. What happened to Nikki? Well, he probably passed out.
What, did he pay for somebody to come grab him and put him in a van or something?
Whoa. He paid for someone to put him in a van?
All of a sudden, they had to, like, there's a hood over his face. They can't get it over the beard,
God.
But they're just dragging him. They're fighting him.
Oh, fuck. I got to go get alcohol now.
What do you want to do? I'll drink a little with you. I got that coffee fucking... Jameson. I'll have some.
I got beer. I got a shitload of beer.
Do you? See, by the way, that shit's really Nikki, good. If you haven't tried it, the coffee one is amazing.
Nikki said he had a meeting to go to.
Oh.
All right.
Meeting.
Clan meeting.
What a clan meeting! Yeah, after that fucking Nazi stuff. He's fucking. He
brought his, I brought my pressure washer.
I'm sorry. What else would you be doing at a meeting at midnight on a Friday? This guy's fucking going to a Klan meeting.
You can't see the cross burn in the daytime.
I know. I'm telling you, there's something up with this shit. That's fucking weird.
I love it. Probably means he's going to have a fuck meeting.
Oh my God, man. Going thank him. You. Thank you, Welsh.
Wild and already did the yard work. Now it's time to do the. Other yard work. Man. I come up with a fucking name. Damn it, it wasn't even.
There's AJ work. Adams down there. I'll throw him up there.
No, anyway, I'm a poor. Like, go get your booze, dude. We'll hold it down.
Yeah, get your booze.
Hey, anybody else wants to jump on Discord, let me know. I will get you over here.
Hold it down.
You hold it down tonight.
All right.
That didn't age well. He made a song about rape.
Oh, it's a great song. Damn it! You know they should have been rocking the Halloween wig at the fucking at the whatever the fuck the rallies or riots or whatever they do. Like whenever that happened, that's all you should have do a clip with that song in the background. Oh my God!
Oh,
can you imagine someone bumping that shit?
Oh my God! I mean, I think
Leah
was.
Like, no, I can't. That's my one of my favorite parts.
Well, it's funny that Leah got mad at Drew that night because she seemed to like that song pretty well for a long time.
You know? She liked that. What the same part I just mentioned. I think that got her.
Right.
Oh, it's good though. It is a good song. I mean, anyone who doesn't laugh at that just doesn't deserve to laugh.
Wait. So what's wrong with it? It's a rape song now.
Anyway, cheers.
The fuck?
Oh, cheers, Jesse.
Oh hell no.
You dirty bastard.
If that's a rape song, you don't listen to Rammstein either. They hope there's some even weirder shit in their mother's milk and goddamn it, whatever the fuck.
Mother. Oh, dude, how weird is
that?
No, do you remember that? I read, I sang the lyrics. I sang the Rammstein lyrics in English.
Yeah, but what did we went into what it was about. Between me, the chat, and you, like, we all figured out, like, what it was about, or somebody knew, or whatever.
Nah,
it was
bro.
About,
no, listen,
oh my God.
Dude, check
not
this
abortion,
out.
But about, like, it was, like, not having your, being taken away from your mother or some shit too early. Some weird shit.
Yes. No, it was Mutter.
What song was it?
Or Mutter or whatever. It was Mutter.
Oh yeah, that one.
Yeah, no, let's look at this. Ready? Here it is. Look, I got the song. Where is it? Is this it? Whoops. Daddy don't know won't hurt him. I got a picture of D. Welsh for the $100. We're back live. Everybody say, tell everybody to refresh. We are back. Just tell everybody to refresh.
All right.
What's up, guys? I'm back. Computer crashed.
Okay.
Don't know why, but.
It happens.
It did.
Dude, I'm glad that you could stay on the same stream because, man, when my shit crashes, I have to fucking make something new.
You shouldn't have to make anything new. You're doing something
wrong.
Now, back in the day, you did, though. Back in the day, you did. Like that was the worst.
Maybe it's just a different issue that takes Gargut's down or something.
Maybe it's something else. But yeah, you should be.
I
able
even
to...
noticed you having to do that, Gargut's. You haven't had to do that in a long time, where you had to start like four different parts in one night. Like I haven't seen that in forever. So, I don't know.
Right.
Yeah, I haven't either. My shit's because I got a new computer. Remember, and the shit has more memory, more RAM.
Oh yeah, you just got new problems now.
Better.
You have sex problems now. We're back live, everybody. We're back. Just refresh.
AJ Adams is here. I'm not sure if he's here though, or what.
Well, he's probably dead. He's probably high and drunk and on drugs. That's my guess with AJ Adams. He's always, right. I mean, he's always on drugs. That guy. All right, I'm gonna go get my.
Sounds about right.
Downers until you are done with your call. Damn it.
I actually owe more than that because D. Welsh. I was gonna take a shot for $22. You were asking me.
I'm drinking too, dude. I'll take half of it with you. I mean, I poured at least four shots in this goddamn glass.
I'm gonna pour four because that was $100, bro. I gotta do it.
Oh,
I'm gonna chug.
I was gonna say you could do two. I'll do two, and then we could save.
Oh, we can do that. I mean, you know.
I was just trying to save you from not killing yourself. But, like, if he decides to drop another bomb, like at least it's split amongst you and me.
But I will say for the rest of the night, though, I'll do $22, man, because I like the phone. I like the phone booth song. So.
Oh, that's cool. And I have this shit, which is only 30%. So, like, I'll be cool. I'll just drink this.
Okay. Well, it'll be a fun little game we can play all night. And tomorrow night's monetized this.
Do when you go to a, I should not be doing this. I'm stupid.
Whoa.
Oh my god.
Well, when you go to a chiropractor, get shit all moved around and shit. The worst, last thing you should do is drink, which doesn't usually stop me, but I mean, fuck it.
From the makers of Fuck It.
Whoa.
They
get
said,
that fucking, what do you got to drink? You got some whiskey? Whoa.
I don't know, man. You know what? I think I've got Captain and I think I've got, I don't know what I have.
You had Jameson the other night. You had the regular stuff.
I think I've drank all the Jameson. I got to be honest.
I do, just drink whatever, you know. It, like I said, I've got enough to cover you. So, or whatever, if I have to. What do you got over there, Garguts? You better have some fucking alcohol besides beer.
All I have is fucking six-pack of Lone Star and 240s.
Well then, all right. So I guess we can translate. Like instead of shots or whatever the fuck, you could always chug a 40 if we get desperate.
Like chug this fucking Lone Star.
I'm just trying to think ahead because I know D. Welsh, dude, and he'll drop bombs.
I'll chug the fuck out of his Lone Star.
You'll
probably see me throw up afterwards, but I'm waiting for my.
You're waiting for your wine? What?
Waiting for his wiener.
No, waiting for my burger to go down because I got Wendy's earlier and I was just
Yeah, you're not gonna want to chug a motherfucking 40 after that. Hell nah. Just don't try
and
chug.
That's why I was hitting a bowl. I was like, once I hit a few bowls, I feel good now. So
tomorrow.
Now I'm ready to start chugging.
Yeah, Joseph, SmackDown was boring and he didn't even like AEW. I get you there. Jimmy Joyce, that's a good point. $33 is the fucked up dono. All right, I'll do the 33 then. How about that? Or 20. Fuck, I want to keep it short. I don't know. All right, let me go grab the bottle. I'm right back.
I'm just trying to keep you from going so fucking, you know.
Yeah, that's a good point.
Crazy. That's all, because there's always tomorrow, too.
Dude,
and I have other shit I can, like, drink to minimize the, so I don't kill my body, because, like, I'm going to wake up in pain no matter what, but this will make it worse, guaranteed. So.
Like, what, some fucking, like, Gatorade or something?
No, I have better than that. I have electrolytes. Putting anything, but I have light beer, I have fucking Fat Tire, I have some IPA, I have three different Jamesons. I mean, I've got a lot of different stuff I can, you know. But I'm just gonna stick with this for now.
Damn.
The coffee Jameson is really good, and it doesn't fucking fuck you up. Kind of keeps you chill, man. I don't know. It's like. I don't think it makes you awake or anything, but it doesn't kill you. Like, you don't feel.
It's like your store,
up.
Like, is your store like an hour away? Because I feel like that's why you're always loaded up with all that fucking alcohol.
No. Actually, I just got these from the locals up here, which if I go about an hour or so away, I can go to a place where you can get alcohol of every kind from all over the world. And that's, I could probably get this Jameson, which by buying two, it was like $16.99. I probably can get it for like, $13.99 over it. I'm gonna guess. I haven't tried to look, but you or no. Better yet, I'll probably be able to get like a 2 liter of the shit for like $35 or something. I don't know.
You probably get weed there. You could probably get fucking
no. But you can get like, I mean, you can get some amazing wine and some great boot, like the Iron Maiden beer that I like. I can only find it there, and I can't even find it there. Plus, you can get cigars. I love that place, dude.
Yeah, fucking,
if you like to do some drinking,
found...
you know.
I haven't found a Stone Cold beer in a while.
I thought that was on Amazon.
It's like, no, yeah, it's on Amazon, but like, it's right here at the
Better deal.
Store.
Better deal. Yeah. If you can go anywhere near you, for sure. You know what you do, dude? If you're cool with the, I used to get the offer all the time. I never took it. I had a liquor store that he used to have a lot of stuff, but if there was something you want and you gave him good business, he would order whatever the fuck you wanted through his license or whatever.
Sparks.
And just Sparks. For you, like maybe your guy can do that. And like, what are you some?
Maybe.
Oh, you want Sparks? Oh my god.
Yeah. I haven't had Sparks in so long.
Oh, you know what? Well, how much alcohol was in those things? I know they were like 24 ounces or 16.
Five for the orange, six for the black, and
I never had anything but the orange.
Wow.
Nice. Ah, fuck that,
and
though.
They
have, I don't
like,
know,
purples
man.
And other
ones. I just feel like such a fucking, either a teenager, somebody in a trailer park, or just, that's about it. Those are who drink Sparks. Who the fuck else drinks Sparks? People on parole?
Dude, I have, oh, I used to, I used to drink it when I fucking started drinking, and that was when it had that all that fucking bad shit, that guarana and taurine.
Taurine and the guarana. It doesn't have that no more anymore? Yeah.
Ginseng. Now.
Wait, doesn't it? Yeah. Don't they still make, they what do they make sports with now? That was all that was in it. Oh, then what good is it? What do they put in there now? I'm curious. Like,
well, that's what I'm saying. Well, before it went out.
Vitamin B.
They started like taking that shit out, and it was it was basically they were just. It still tasted the same though.
Oh, so I just bought a Coke energy thing, and I felt stupid. Why are they taking it? I mean, I don't know. I bought one of those Coke energies, and I'm like, I don't have any Coke anyway, so it's like wasn't a waste. But I looked at it after I bought it. I was like, it has like just a tiny ass bit of B6, and it has taurine or whatever. One of the two. It was fucking nothing. I'm like, it's the caffeine in it that's stronger than anything in this thing. What do you mean Coke energy? It's just Coke, you fucking assholes. I don't know. I don't get it. Like, if you're going to fucking do it, you know? I mean,
mix it with alcohol and see what happens.
Well, it's like, all you can do is, like, load up on B12s and shit and, like, the stuff that's... No, even if you take pre-workout shit, like, that shit'll work well, but it has a lot of the bad shit in it, too. Like, there's not that many things you can... Kratom, that works, I guess. Get the white one. Most people do the green one.
What?
Kratom. You never had or heard of? People call it kratom or whatever. I believe it's kratom.
Oh yeah, but kratom. Yeah.
I've used it, but it's like, and so like the white one, because I was trying to get rid of anything I was taking at the time, which it isn't going to work for that. But if you're like, say for like ADD or whatever, or if you want like an upper effect, their white ones are for that, like the white strain, the green strains for like pain, downer or upper, and then the red shit is little like that just knocks your ass out. But you're really like, I don't know, like, well, I don't, I'm trying to think what else you could use. Like, I would don't get no sparks. It ain't even got the stuff that kills you in it. Fuck that.
Well, I mean, you could probably mix it with the stuff that goes. You could probably get like an energy drink and then fucking throw it all in there and mix it.
It's just gonna be a seltzer or whatever the fuck. It's going to be one of those things with sparkling water and a little alcohol and a touch of B12, and then they'll call it a sparks. I was looking at those fucking, what are they, seltzer sets, whatever the fuck, and I was like the light beer with flavoring or whatever. I'm like, what the fuck is sparkling water with alcohol? What is this shit? No, dude, no, you can't fucking do that.
Yeah, that's just terrible.
I mean, it's probably better than Mike's terrible, and shit.
It tastes like watered down Kool-Aid. Tastes like watered down Kool-Aid to me. It's not very good. But it gets you fucked up if you drink like
they do.
Five.
Oh fuck. Yeah. Really? I've seen you drink 18 motherfucking 16-ounce Alamo beers and not even fucking how the fuck do five of those unless you're drinking tall cans.
You drink five of them, you drink five of them with a girl, you'll be fucking her and like
the girl, that's a different story. Wait, fuck it. I wouldn't drink that with a chick even. Like, no, we're drinking fucking wine. The farthest I'll go is I'll drink a fucking rosé with a chick because, all right. But that's it. We're drinking like something else. I ain't gonna fucking drink no goddamn goofy fucking fuckity fuck shit. I saved it.
Wow.
Oh, dude, I'm not even that picky. I'm kidding. But I honestly am not gonna do it just because I'm
a chick,
that's for sure. Like, I'm buy her that shit, but I ain't.
Just imagine if
you broke up. Go ahead.
You buy her that shit, and she's just like, imagine if you buy her that shit, and she's just like, I don't want this pussy ass shit.
That's why, I wouldn't even.
Like, well, fuck.
I mean, most of the people I've been, the people I've been with, like, they'll drink that kind of stuff, like, once in a blue moon, but nah, they like to like drink real beer and like real. Like good wine and shit. Like, we're not. Fuck that shit. Otherwise, I'm not gonna. Oh, dude, I'm not. Sparks. That is gross, man. God damn you. I'd drink the black one though if I was really broke. Now that I know there's a black one.
Yeah, no, not because it's black. One was fucking awesome,
because it's
man.
Strong. Well, yeah, I bet, it's dude. I mean, would you say 9%? I mean. It goes one of two ways when you have 9% alcohol in it or more. Seven? When you start getting up into 8, 9s and like 12, you're risking it tasting like pure bitter shit. And like if they could mix flavor with and have it that high, you found a good beer or whatever it is. I mean, it's rare though. Fucking, I bought a Sam Adams that did that shit. They were, it was a 4-pack. They were 12% alcohol, and it tasted like purple piss. And I threw them away.
Dude,
they were devil's, gross, dude.
The Devil's Backbone. Did you try the Devil's Backbone yet? Those shits will fuck you up.
Now it's another one.
You
drink
with the girl, like, and
what is
she's
that?
Fucking you. It's an IPA.
Oh, it's one of those. Like, okay.
Probably
it's
like
a,
nine,
oh, it's an IPA.
To 12,
nice.
9 to 12% alcohol. Backbone.
100% alcohol, 200%
yeah, that's not
gonna
boy
be
cum. Here. I gotta look in a bigger place.
200% boy cum.
200.
Mm.
That's a Ryback would do.
That's a.
I mean, you know,
that's a rainbow shot.
I mean, I'll take two.
No, I'll take two. Holy fuck.
I was
two rainbow shots.
Shampoo in the boy's hair. Took me back to an Herbal Essence commercial I jerked off to.
Get out of my fucking chat.
Older man.
Get out of my chat
younger
right
than
now. I'll kill you.
Whoa.
The bartender,
I mean,
has to jizz in the fucking thing.
Ugh. I'm pouring drinks right
dude,
now.
Dude, what was who the fuck? Dude, in your fucking Discord, Gargots, who the fuck showed us a can of, like, carbonated Reaper fucking peppers or something? Like, I looked at that and went, what the fuck is that? Like, they were about to drink that shit. It was like on, it said something ice. And I'm like, who the fuck puts like these fucked up peppers in this shit? What is that?
Speaking of Discord, where the like, fuck is everybody, man? Talk about quiet.
Oh, man, who knows? They're all fucking. Well, if it was, I don't know. Shit.
That's
it's
what I'm
usually
saying.
Loaded.
Where
up,
is but... everybody? I feel the same way.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. The fuck is everybody?
They're watching
I mean,
through. No.
What?
I'm kidding.
The creamer?
No, they probably missed Drew. Drew's not around. Oh, I was saying they're watching. Oh, it's, I was. What started me to say that was that maybe it says Drew's not around.
Oh, maybe.
People miss him. I mean, no.
I mean,
he is actually.
The kid.
I was yelling at him yesterday. Come back.
Yeah, right? Yeah, Jesus.
I'm surprised he hasn't been clipping.
Oh, yeah, I bet he's been clipping.
He's
he
been
just clitting. Hasn't told anyone.
Yeah, he's been clitting.
No, he's probably been like fucking
cutting,
like
cutting.
Doing what he does at hotel rooms, which is he loves to fucking put little hidden cameras around and try to catch women's skirts and pussies. Swear to God.
He said he catches a bunch of dicks.
No, I'm telling you, man, he goes to these hotels and he puts little hidden cameras in the bathrooms. I'm telling you. He puts a wig on to dress like a woman.
What good is that when he's the only one that's going to use the bathroom?
No, he goes to like the lobby, like down where public bathrooms.
Oh, all right.
Yeah, and he goes in. He goes in with a fucking wig on, like a full wig, like a woman dressed up like in a dress and everything.
Dude,
and
he could just say he's a dyke. I mean, he's got short hair. It'll work.
Well,
great.
That I mean, maybe
unless
that's true. But then he puts down. I mean, this is all allegedly. But then he puts down like a. He's put fake smoke detectors in bathrooms. He's put fake, like soap dispensers in there. And then, like, at the end of the week, he goes home and he edits the footage all together. Then he puts, like, what's that band? Love Shack, the band that does B-52s. Yeah, the B-52s.
Oh, B-52s. I was fucking close. That is weird. What is with me?
Yeah,
dude. No, I said Blink. Ah, fuck it. B-182. I was close.
Right. And he like, edits all the women, like, all the women touching their breasts, looking in the mirrors. All the women, like... taking their clothes off in the bathrooms, and he puts fucking like Love Shack Baby.
Goodness!
Every
dude,
time,
dude, that does sound like something that Drew would jam his ass off to.
You know why just he does it? I think when he was raped as a kid by his family, that the B-52 song was playing in the background one time. I think that's what it is.
Or they sent him to the shack, but it wasn't to get a beating; it was to get it eaten.
Yeah, the meat shack.
Dick.
Go ahead and see Dad. He's in
the
back.
I don't know, dude, but that when you said that he would do that to the Love Shack song, I really do think, like, if that comes on the radio, Drew's singing.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. You know it.
He's coming.
And he's coming. Eric Travis, thanks for subbing to the channel, Eric Travis. What's going on?
Jesus.
I feel like he's been subbed a while. It's weird.
Who's that?
Yeah, we feel the same way.
Oh, you know it. Aaron Thomas. Thanks for
subbing
to the channel.
Oh, I was one. Travis. Okay.
Oh, and it was Geddy Lee that had the fucking pepper extract.
Like in real life? Okay. You mean Geddy Lee from the show or like the real Geddy Lee?
Geddy Lee. No,
oh my God, Stewie Griffin subscribed. That's amazing. That's what we've been waiting for. All right, here you go.
Stewie Griffin.
All right.
We're starting off with this vanilla Smirnoff vodka.
Oh, cheers.
I don't know. I probably drank about 2 shots worth so far. I'll finish up.
You damn right. You don't. It's something you damn don't do. Cheers.
Drinking with Eddie. Cheers. I'm telling. Oh, that face don't look good.
You know,
dude, you and Anthony Cumia both make the biggest faces when you guys like take a shot. It's hilarious.
The first shots of the night are always rough, like for me. It's always like, oof. Yikes.
That's how I am when I take my first sip of scotch or Canadian whiskey because they're so strong. But like, and then after that, I'm down. But like Jameson, I can just, no problem. Because it doesn't do that. It's pretty light.
Really?
I accidentally breathed my
beer. Yeah, I mean,
right now.
They don't have much taste. That's what I kind of like about it is that it's one, if you're not looking to like have extreme body in your drink, like Jameson's fine. They have one that's like a dark aged whatever, and it's like $10 more. And I'm like, I'll buy that somewhere better where I can get a better price. It probably tastes really strong though. I bet. I mean,
tequila. Do you like it?
Oh yeah. Silver. Like I could drink that right out of the bottle, but I gotta be in the mood. Like I'm not a tequila drinker, but
there ain't no better thing than a good old margarita. No, I'm just kidding. I'm sorry. I'm joking.
No, I mean I like I don't like tequila unless it's like silver.
Don't make me pull the Jimmy Buffett concert out again.
Oh dude. Swear you people, how the hell did you get here?
Jimmy Buffett doing the name game?
Fucking terrible. God.
That was really funny though, Joe. I was checking that out. Like that shit is gold.
Oh, here's the this is the crowd.
When he dies, you gotta fucking pump that thing out.
They get louder every time. Boy, I tell you what, all you parrot heads are looking wonderful tonight. And nothing looks better than a parrot head in Margaritaville on Pride Month. How about that? Yeah. I know you parrot heads of Pride Month. We'll hear more from Jimmy Buffett later on, but you know what? I watched a old Dateline NBC or something thing on Jimmy Buffett because we've been talking so much about him recently that I was like, and he's like the only country I've listened to. I don't normally like country at all, and he's not country. He's like country mixed with the island flavor weird thing. But you know, in the interview,
you're making country.
Yes, well, he's like culturally appropriating island music with country music.
But well, that's what you call. I just call it white people music.
I was gonna say, is he like UB, like a UB40 fucking mix into country or something?
Yeah, I mean, he's like a weird. He's got that island.
Red.
Well, I mean, think about the song Volcano, right? The Jimmy Buffett Volcano song. He's like, he sings it like he's with an accent. He's like, la la peep. How about Jollyman? Jolly man sing when the supper every night. Like, it's like, he's fucking, how is he not canceled?
Oh, my God.
Think about it. How is he not canceled for that? Like, whoa, jolly man sing. Like, he's fucking, and the island music is going on. It's like he's appropriating island music with country. Oh, my God, cancel him. UB40 fucking music. Foot rub killed, you killed foot rub.
UB40. I never even heard of that shit.
But I
Oh, wait, you've heard of UB40, the looking red. Well, you've heard that song. Oh. Come on, dude. Early 90s. Come on.
Is that the same one that goes, wind your hips, wind your. I think that's the same people.
I don't know. Oh, no, they did a lot of songs.
I know what you're talking about.
They're not a bad band, though,
wind your body. Wind your body.
Not bad.
Wind your body.
That's fucking hilarious.
It was a while before I realized the singer was a white dude, though. When I first saw him sing, I'm like, ha! No shit.
Yeah, Sting's like, kind of like that, too. Sting had that sort of vibe, too. Where Sting would act.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that's...
Wait, are you talking about The Police, right? Or are you talking about when Sting came out solo?
Whatever.
Because I never really listened to his shit.
Yeah, The Police, especially early Police, right?
Yeah, Police, for sure.
It was like somebody...
They were, yeah...
It was like somebody tipped him off at some point. They were like, yo, Sting, you should cut that shit out, bro. You're white as fuck. Like, that's weird. And he was like, okay.
I don't know. Yeah, I like you. Those songs are the shit.
You don't have
though.
To
they're
put
great.
On your red light. Like what the fuck, bro? But Jimmy,
oh, Roxanne.
Yeah, but fuck Jimmy yeah. Buffett does that too in the Volcano song. Like, I don't know where I'm going to go when the volcano blows. It's like, what the
oh
fuck?
Oh, my God.
Think about it.
God damn.
Welcome to Gullah
Gullah. Yeah, I was about to say the same shit. Just welcome to Gullah Gullah Island, but that was like black people.
Were you too. Really, dude? What the fuck,
dude?
Jeez.
Yeah, dude. That's exactly what it reminded me of right
that's
now.
That's funny. That's hilarious.
Jesus Christ.
What the fuck, dude? I got to start listening to other shit that I think. Holy fuck. I might be on a roll for at least a day.
But I mean, I see a lot of white girls, they do reggae. That's not racist or whatever. That's it's music.
Ah, fuck that. Dude,
we don't care.
No, it's not racist.
We
holy
don't care
fuck,
here,
no.
but we don't care here, but it's other people that you know, like when they like I mean shit, I don't know, Jimmy Buffett flies
problem.
Under the radar
cut
so much.
Drums out.
When I
people
see
that
it though,
bitch about music.
That's
fuck.
Why like I think about nowadays when I hear Jimmy Buffett's thing, I'm like, man, I'm surprised he's not in trouble for that right now. Like, but
not
dude,
yet.
I heard this interview with him for an hour long, and at one point he's like, "Well, some of the fans, you know, are pretty over the top and whatever." And he's like, "I love them though, you know, they do this." And then he finally goes, "I just wish that some of them would cool it down, you know, or whatever." And I was like, "Oh my God, you fucking, he's shitting on his parrot heads." He's like, he literally was like, "I just wish, you know, some of them, you know, take it a little too seriously or whatever." And I was like, "Ooh."
Yeah.
Oh my God!
But he's the one that for years is like, it. "We're going to Margaritaville and the bars," and he sells all the shit, and it's like, "Well, what the fuck? You're selling this big gimmick." I mean, of course they fucking think it's real. God damn it! Fucking hilarious. Jesse, is that you in the chat? Should I mod you?
Yeah, that's me.
All right, don't be careful.
I am, dude. I'm at least 9.5 out of 10 correct anymore.
Yeah,
I mean, come on. I only stay away from when you're doing wrestling. Like tonight's a mix, but like when you're doing a wrestling one, I don't watch enough to know your audience there. So I don't even bother there because I don't want to fuck up. But I know the people that come into Corrupted or Monetize This or Gargots or shit. I know pretty much everybody. So
well, tomorrow night we're going to have we're going to start at about around 10 p.m. for Monetize This tomorrow.
Woo!
So Saturday night, Monetize This 10. Joe, get Cody on. I don't think Cody's on. He's not on hold. Nobody else is on hold.
So what's the thing with Corrupted? Is that like later tonight or is that another day?
We're going to do another day this week. Yeah, we're going to do another day this week.
Cool.
There's the chat right there. Nobody's on hold, so I can't put Cody on hold. Cody wants to come on there. Can Shell see yet? No, I don't know. I think she can, but.
I haven't talked to her or heard from her since. I think the last time she donated or whatever.
I don't
that's
know.
The last
but
I heard anything.
The other day, like 4 days ago, Shell was here. She dropped
yeah,
it.
Yeah, within the. Mm-hmm. Something like that.
I got to tell you, though, Jesse, somebody in the chat, Vincent Wolf said, "Damn, you look
shit
sexy
bomb!
As fuck or cute as fuck.
You become a shit bum."
Oh, shit. There's Cody right there.
Happy Friday, Joe and crew.
Thank you, Cody. Oh, man. He told me something about his girl. He said
Friday.
He said his girl might be doing something, posing for us for something.
Nice.
Like
all
a pictures,
right.
maybe,
hey,
or something.
Hey. Fuck yeah. That's what you gotta do. I mean, dude, even like, I don't know what you do.
Yeah. Cody and me and Cody are supposed to tag team her.
So. Well, no, like, I'm just down for people, like, I don't know, doing shit like that. I'm like, whatever, dude, embrace your sexuality. Go do a fucking titty shot. Somewhere.
I'm hoping to see some pictures of her, and that's you know, that's gonna be crazy. You know what I realized the other day? I was thinking about this, and maybe you don't care. Maybe nobody cares about them. That's why they're dead. But I was like, yo, what happened to the band Shiny Toy Guns? What happened to them? Is what I was thinking.
I know the name. I don't remember any songs, or I don't know that. If
see,
I remember the name too.
Oh my God!
When was it? When were they out? Like early the 2000s, or
yeah, like 2005. And then,
all right.
And then
are they like an emo band? Are they one of those fucking bands that I'll never know?
Probably.
All right. That other band that with the HIM, whatever.
But
the
I like
fuck
them.
That band was I didn't know them. I don't know any of them really.
Okay, let me see. Would you recognize this? Yeah, this was on the this was their first hit on the radio.
I used to have a lot of K-Rock shit. So maybe.
We played this. We played this
don't
before.
Mind if
I think
do.
We did this exact
What's my
thing.
Name? Oh. Dunkachino.
It's a whole new game.
Dunkachino.
You want creamy goodness? I'm your friend. Say hello to my chocolate blend.
Hi, what's up, new here?
Whoa, what's going on? Eric Fair, thanks for the $5. Hey, what's going on? Yeah, we got through talking with, you know, we really did. I missed a lot of AEW and wrestling tonight because I was out doing my wrestling show, doing commentary somewhere. So now we're just hanging out. It's a late night, Friday night throwdown, live on the channel. And then tomorrow night we'll be live again. So welcome to the show, Eric. Thanks for the $5 very much. That was nice of you. And then
what
we
are they
got,
called? Chinky toy guns?
Oh, shiny toy guns. Mm-hmm.
China toy gun.
You ever hear this on the radio? This was on the radio.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, okay. That's not as annoying as I thought it was going to be. All right. I mean, I like some, like, the Kills. I like them, and they do some stuff like that sometimes. So I'm like, I can, all right.
So this is, I like their, I like their third CD. The listen to this one's a little bit more. It's very Depeche.
I think of Scarface and playing the game Scarface.
That's this
with
sounds
the fucking soundtrack playing.
This one sounds a lot more like Depeche Mode.
Yeah.
Dunkachino? Don't mind if I do. What's my name? Dunkachino. It's a
whole new. But they completely disappeared. I don't know what happened.
You
want creamy goodness?
I'm your friend. Well, say hello to my chocolate blend.
Want to join the Discord?
Oh, all what's right. going on, Eric? Okay. I got the link here. I've been putting it out, but it disappears.
Wait, that might... Is that the motherfucking target that sends like five different fucking friend requests at a time?
Oh, really? Is he psycho?
Not in a bad way. Not in like a troll way. Just like the... I think he's just been wanting to like...
Thanks, Eric.
Get in the... I don't know.
No?
I don't know.
Yo, what Cody.
Yo.
What's up, Cody?
Nothing. Just got done with some business.
Nice.
So,
does that mean
wash the blood off your shoes? Some people forget at the end.
You're inside her. Inside of her. Inside of her.
I ain't gotta wash that blood off. That's all good. No.
Inside her ass. He was inside her ass. We're gonna have the same lineup on monetize this tomorrow night. Just so you know.
Joe, did you hear about that fucking?
Hey, it's all right.
Did you hear about that fucking
dude? Luke better be here, though. Son of a bitch. Sorry.
Try again.
The whale? Massachusetts?
The whale. There could be a lot of... There's a lot of fat bitches here.
Fucking whale.
What?
A whale. he got swallowed by a whale, and the whale...
What?
Fucking gnawed on him for like 30 seconds, and then spit him out. They said... The fishermen that were around him just said they saw his legs coming out of the fucking water like a fucking rocket.
Gordon's fishermen.
I would fucking love to see that.
Oh my god! Wait, that happened.
I mean, no, wait. So the guy survived. He was like, oh my god, that's like that is straight up Moby Dick, but the real story. Like, I mean,
we're gonna need a bigger boat.
Oh my god, dude! Why would fuck whales? Fuck Willie.
Try suck him up. Some of that shit.
Wait a minute. Someone got eaten by a shark in Massachusetts today, and I didn't even
know.
No,
a whale. A fucking whale.
Wait.
That's even stranger, though.
Oh,
no,
yeah.
It was a whale.
Oh, a whale tried to eat a guy in Massachusetts.
Yeah.
That makes it even weirder, though, than a shark. The hell?
Yeah, they act sweet and shit. They talk to you. Whatever the fuck that movie said showed. Harmonica bullshit. And then they bite you.
So it was.
Fuck Willie.
It was probably the blue humpback one, and then like even if you get swallowed with that, I heard that like the fucking esophagus is like a drain, like the size of a drain. So you wouldn't be swallowed, so you'd be able to they spit you out. So like that's what he just
they'll chew you up, spit you out.
Aww.
It's a song.
That sucks. He couldn't finish his meal. Poor whale.
Humpback bitch.
Damn.
I was like ready to kill the whale a second ago, and then I heard he didn't. He couldn't even. He never stood a chance with this fucking asshole. What? Don't go near its mouth. You can't even. Jesus.
See, actually,
dude, did you hear me say humpback bitch, dude? Humpback bitch, dude.
Yep.
That's what they used to call Casey as Raw's mother. Go ahead, Garguts. No. I'm sorry.
Wait, what is she called now?
No, you're good. That was a good one. That's even better.
Gullible.
I said I saved the fucking.
They call her Gullible Whore now. Go ahead.
Whoa. All right.
Thank you, Cody Mastro. Go ahead, Gargots. What were you saying? I'm sorry.
I got nothing.
Oh, he was asking if you'd heard about it, I think, because it was in your area.
Yeah, no, see, I didn't hear it. Yeah. Didn't hear about it at all. I had no idea. I heard about it. There was something else locally that I did hear about, though. Or maybe I'm thinking of my kids this morning. Dude, my, you know what my kids did this morning? I know it's weird, but no, I'm not kidding. My daughter goes, can you put on she goes, John, where he goes, dun, 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 dun. And I go, what? And so I'm like, she goes, just look it up. And I'm like, oh, it's some kind of, is she talking about Jaws or something? Like, so she must be talking about some kind of video that has the Jaws theme in it. So she goes, no, it's called like John, dun, dun. And I go, okay. And she goes, and then after a few minutes, I was like, are you talking about Jaws? And she goes, yeah, Jaws. And I'm like, yeah, like the theme song, like dun, 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 dun. She goes, yes, it's the scene. It's so funny. Mommy watched it the other day, and I saw it, and I was laughing so hard. It's so funny. And I'm like, what, is it some kind of Jaws meme or something? She goes, yeah, something like that. You just have to type in Jaws, and it will come up eventually. And I'm like, okay. So I'm like, there's some kind of new Jaws meme that all the kids know about. So I type in Jaws. We start scrolling, and she goes, that's it. That's it. And I go, that looks like a scene from Jaws. And it's the scene where the fucking little boy and the blood comes up and the boy dies. And I click on it, and we're watching it, and we see the whole scene. And I'm like, this is just the movie, and this is horrific. You shouldn't be watching this. What the hell is this? And she's like, oh, I saw Mom was watching it the other day. It's really funny. I'm like, you thought that was funny? She goes, well, it's sad. It's sad, but it's kind of funny. And I'm like, what the fuck? Dude, the kids think it's funny.
Dude, I mean, it's your kid. What do you expect?
She thinks it's fucking hilarious. She thinks Jaws is funny.
Of course. Dude, she's either going to have her own podcast or she will take your shit over like fucking whatever. Be like a Stephanie McMahon Triple H situation. Because, dude, she's already fucking killing it. Like, the stories you tell, I'm like, Jesus Christ, it really is your kid. Like, like Leah probably like feels like she's not even in. It's like, yep, that's just your crazy one. Take her.
Oh, yeah, she can't. They get in fights all the time. She's like, you deal with that. That's you.
I knew it. I fucking that's knew what I it. Because it's, oh my God, I love that. Though, and you got like, you have like Gavin, who's like, you know, got like Leah, and then, you know, fucking, she's a lot like you. And then, like, where does Finn, like,
he's like,
is he more like both of you or?
He's got like, he's like a big sweetheart, but then has rage. It's weird.
Ooh, little bit of both then. Well,
yeah,
hey,
like,
wait a minute.
Like he'll be like, oh, you know what? I love you, mommy and daddy. And then, but then if you're like, oh, it's time to go to bed, he'd be like, no, I hate this. And he'll throw something.
Well, I love that he's the one that was like, he's the one that like trolled Gavin, like, let's go.
Oh, yeah, he trolled
that
Gavin.
That was great.
Yeah.
Oh my God, dude.
Gavin's like mad at the 5-year-old. He's like, shut up. And Finn's like, let's go.
God damn it. That blows me away that he's already. I remember, dude, when I first found you, Gavin was 5. Like, right. It blows me away. Like, when I hear you say that shit now, every time I'm like, what the fuck? We're getting old. Sucks.
We getting old and we're dying. Well, Leah's always like, I need another girl because this one's fucking crazy.
Oh, I thought she meant like lesbian action.
I'm like, no. Oh, yeah, that'd be great. No, that'd be awesome.
That'd be
you
awesome,
Janelle,
yeah.
You got Janelle for that. There you go.
Well, you guys already went to you guys can't do that anymore, right? Didn't she already go that route?
No, she could get the thing out of her and probably get pregnant, but it'd be kind of like, it's getting borderline now because she's 33 and I'm 36, so.
Oh, well.
It's getting. We can still do.
She's still
good.
On her health.
I mean, you can have one till 40-ish time, but it's more dangerous.
Well, no, you're not
risky. Isn't it really risky around that time?
Yeah, it gets risky.
Well, no, it depends. It depends on the person. Like my ex, she almost died giving birth to her kid, and they told her prior to that she would never have a kid. It was like he happened, but then she literally almost died. So she had pre-issues that like they already knew well before she got pregnant. Like if you carry them really well, you know, like it shouldn't be a problem. And even in your 40s, shouldn't be a problem.
My cousins actually.
Body, I mean,
my cousins named their dog Finnegan as well. It's kind of funny. And we were like, really? We just named our kid Finn.
Everybody watches too much Game of Thrones or something.
Well, they don't. They don't. I don't know why they got this name, but I was like, we just named our kid Finn. Now you got a dog named Finnegan? That's funny.
Aw.
Come here. Come here, Finn, you little fucking Finn. Come over here, you little fuck.
The funny thing is you'll probably have to crate train Brenna, not Finn.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, it's true. No, it's true. No, he doesn't pee anything, and he fucking goes to the bathroom on his own, does everything. Never pees That's anything. Brenna's peeing all over the place every second.
No, fuck.
My daughter's peeing on everything. Fucking everything's wet. Up, she peed the bed again. Up, she peed this, that, and the other thing. Oh, it's crazy.
Yeah, she was like,
just get extra sheets.
Trying to get you to burn the bear. What, a little while ago, right?
Yeah, the other day she was like, let's burn him.
Yeah, just in the backyard.
What the fuck? I've been telling you that for years. She's on my side, you son of a bitch. Inferno match.
Well, yes. No. Her idea, then she wanted to go. Then the chat said, run the bear over with the car, I think. And then
you ran the bear over with the.
And Brenna was like, yes, let's run the bear over with the car.
Oh, Survivor
Dad.
Series 99.
Right. And she's like, Dad, you have to run it over with the car. And she got like too excited about it. It was weird.
Wow.
Yeah, I know a lot
does
of
she watch does she watch horror movies or anything? Or
no.
Things where there's killing?
No.
Oh.
I mean,
seems like she'd like them.
Yeah, well, except for that Jaws thing, I guess. I mean, I don't know. That was weird that she knew about that. I guess she saw it by accident. But I mean, I saw Jaws when I was
probably,
her age. Dude, when I was 7 years
nowadays,
old,
are they,
I saw RoboCop. Yeah. I saw RoboCop at 7.
Oh, wow, yeah. Well, yeah, though.
But that was horrific, dude. Yeah. You ever seen RoboCop? It's fucking wicked horrific.
Yeah, but it's so weird that that almost doesn't seem like a big deal for some reason. I don't know why.
I mean, I don't know. It's
I mean, I was
crazy.
Watching a lot of yeah, I guess it just depends. I don't know.
It all really depends on what they watch, I guess, because like when I was a couple years ago, I was playing Mortal Kombat, and my niece now just loves anything blood and gore fighting, and she's like 7.
Whoa.
I mean, I remember loving movies at like 6 years old, like Basketball Diaries and shit. Watching a junkie fucking die the whole movie, like six. I don't know. I don't know.
They marketed RoboCop to kids, though,
Duncan
and Rambo.
Chino?
Really?
Yeah, that's I do. Yes. Yeah.
What's my name? Dunkachino. It's a whole new game. Dunkachino. You want creamy goodness? I'm your friend. Say hello to my chocolate
Terminator.
Blend.
All right, I think I'm ready.
All right, I think I'm ready, too. What's that? To fuck Garga? Oh, no, it's Eric. What's up? Yeah, I'll get you in here 1 second. Thank you, man, for the $5. Thank you guys for the donations, keeping the Friday nights lovely and sexy. Tomorrow night is monetized this. Saturday night monetized this. We are wet, as always, now on Saturdays.
It'll be at 10, right?
And we're going to start at 10 p.m., yeah. Other nights, we start at 10, 10:30.
Okay, Joe, or I'm gonna send... Did you just get a message from...
What?
Did you just get a message?
No. Where?
Okay, I did. I'm gonna Discord. Don't worry, they're giving it to me first, but I'm going to send it to you. I'm not going to say what it is.
Okay, send me the secret message because I want to get naughty with you. Let me tell you that.
It's just more like a heads up, you could say.
Heads up!
I'll send it to you on Messenger.
I don't know why that
makes me laugh.
All
right, go ahead. Continue.
That makes me laugh.
Continue. I'm not going to
mention it. That's okay. Look at this. Look at Drew here.
Drew? Lesbian Lips. I miss him. Damn it.
When does he get back? He's got to be back pretty soon, right?
Oh, next week.
I think next week, yeah.
Next week. Damn it.
Here's Finn messing with me when I was doing the show. Remember, he always jumps on. Ha! Can't see it here, but you'll see it in a minute. But yeah, Drew's big meat lips. They're always getting in the way of everything.
Yummy.
What is wrong with this fucking app? I hate Discord so much.
You're really pixelated right now, at least for me, you are.
What's my name? Dunkachino.
See if I can fix it. I might have to swap out and go out and come in on him.
Jesus, why does he do that? Why is
dude, I was ready. I was going to help Gargutz last night, and then I put the math together. I'm like, dude, I'm not going to... It was like $65 I would have had to spend to get his server boosted. I'm like, fuck that, and it's only going to be good for like 30 days.
Right.
Like,
I guess
D. Welsh, what Discord does.
D. Welsh said that Dynamite's in 2 weeks is on Saturday night.
Oh, shit, really?
Yeah.
So where's this?
It's Saturday Night Live with Kevin Nealon. Yo, Lone Wolf, what's up, brother?
Oh, never mind.
Lost him. Let me go see what Eric has to say. Hang on one second, everybody. Chat, 69 in the chat. I got to take my next shot just in a minute. Right after I switch this audio.
Game like that, so.
Oh, it's all good, bro. Let me move you in here. Let me get in there with you. Okay.
Okay.
There we go. All right, I'm back. We're back, everybody. I don't know why, but Eric took off. He was like, nope.
Oh, I wonder why.
Wonder why? Why did Eric take off? That was weird. Mm-hmm.
Oh, dude. God damn it. This is all.
Yo, funny. Luis Antonio Alejandro.
Oh, Joe.
Yo.
The message I just sent you?
Yeah.
That's why. Because Eric, yeah, that's great. Oh, I love how these fuckers are just. Oh, fuck. Dude, they're like roaches, but funner. Can't get rid of them, but you can enjoy killing them. Fuck it.
They're spawning.
Yeah.
You're just spawning. You're spawn
you bitch, dude. You fucking out. That was my last sip of this shit. And I just like, oh.
Spawn did I spit camp.
I'm going to have to pour more. You're a cunt.
Oh,
I'm going to make you fucking drop your 40 later. And you'll be licking it off the fucking concrete.
Oh, my God, dude. I fucking hate doing that shit.
What the fuck? I wasn't being serious. You're going to lick it off the concrete?
No, I said I hate doing, like, dropping the 40. It sucks.
Oh, all right. God damn, dude. I was going to say, calm down. I'll send you $3. You buy another 40.
Yeah, except they don't fucking stop. They stop selling fucking. This isn't Vegas where they fucking don't stop selling.
No, I know, but don't. What are you guys over here? It's 2:00.
It's midnight.
It's 1:30.
Oh, I guess it is 2:00. Yeah, unless you're at a bar.
It's 1:30.
You want to go to a bar?
And.
Yeah, if it's not a bar, I guess you're right. It's around 11 or midnight.
Good call. What time over there, Joe?
Dude, do the math, dude. It's an hour later than you.
No, I'm saying what time do they stop serving over there?
Okay, so like they stop serving at like 1 a.m. Midnight, I think. Actually, now I forget. It's either midnight or 1 a.m.
Oh, that's
on Saturdays,
good.
It's 1 a.m. over here.
I think it's it's usually... It's usually like midnight, I think, and then there's a couple places that sometimes get to be open till 1. But you gotta be like either grandfathered in or you have to pay for that extra something on the license.
Shit bomb!
It's fucking crazy.
You become a shit bomb.
Massachusetts is weird.
Luis Antonio Alejandro. Ooh. Joe, it's Selena time, baby.
Selena time, huh? All right, we'll
fucking
play some
Randy Viper, right? I knew it. God damn it.
We'll have to get some Selena for you later. What's that, Luis?
Fucking what's the Randy cumbia? Viper.
He's
Are
quiet.
You fucking serious?
What? I thought you liked Randy.
How do you know I love Selena Quintanilla?
Because of how you sound?
What the hell?
What the fuck?
Story?
What?
I think the song Bidi Bidi Bam Bam, I fucking danced to when I was a little child.
Oh. I don't know why, but little child coming out of your mouth sounds horrific. I don't know why.
Oh, no. I swear, I'm a huge Selena Quintanilla.
You could say a kid, right?
Buenos dias. Salinas. I love Salinas. I love her. You know what? You know, you never be ashamed of that, Luis, because I love Selena too, man. I think she's fucking. When I was a kid, dude, those songs, I'd jerk off to those songs on the radio to her. I'd be, speaking of that.
Oh my God. Yeah. Oh my God. You're the best. Finish. Oh, you're the best.
No. Finish
oh,
my, it.
Oh God. Finish. I'm going to explode.
Do not come.
Oh, I don't know. I don't think I can hold it.
Do not come.
I got to come. I got to.
Do not come. We did it.
We did it.
Oh my God. There's going to be a donation here soon.
This
man.
Is going to be a donation. What should I make it for? What should I make it for? Watch this. Watch this. Look at this. Now we can do it. Look at this.
Oh my God, yeah. Oh my God, you're the best. Oh, you're the best.
Yeah,
oh my fuck. Oh God, I'm gonna explode.
Do not come.
Oh no.
Oh no, I don't think I can hold it.
Do not come.
I gotta come. I gotta.
Do not come.
We did it.
Finish it.
We did it, Joe.
Speaking of that, by the way, real quick, I just wanted to tell everybody that Casey is raw. By the way, first, DeVicius is the king. Shout out to DeVicius. He puts his crown on the line tomorrow night. I'll monetize this. But Casey is raw. Just wanted to wish you guys all a happy Pride Month. Just wanted to share
yes.
this.
Yes. Oh, my gosh.
So thank you for Casey is raw for sharing his photos. These are also the same photos he sent to one of his lovers that same night. So thank you, Casey is raw, for...
Oh, no.
Look at... Now, he's a hairy person. Let's be honest. He's kind of a hairy guy. Like, he's... Like, there's no escaping the fact that he's a hairy man. Dashmir Burgess, what's up? Thanks for subbing. What's going on? Yeah, he's a real hairy man. What do you think about that?
He's the hairiest guy I know.
Dude, he's a sexy fucking hairy beast. What are we going to do about it?
You think that's... See, I picture, like, boogers in the hair and, like, stuff like that. You know what I mean? Like, just nasty, just gross shit.
Just, like, cum stains.
Like, yeah, crustiness, like, whatever. You know, you take your pick of whatever, like, crust, all that stuff.
Dude, his fucking arm turns into white. Like, if you put that on a scale, I bet you it's just, like, pure white. Look at his left fucking shoulder.
Oh,
and
yeah.
At the top, it's just tanned as fuck.
His face is tanned, but his arms, his whole upper body's just paste.
You know, and he works outside too, so I'm confused.
Does he really?
I'm surprised. Yeah.
Jesse, go see if his mic's working yet, Jesse.
Was construction?
Jesse, you want to do that? Eric?
I'm not.
But in all reality, we love Casey.
You
want to
go over there and see if his mic is working?
Wait, hang on. I can't get even in there.
No, I'll put him in. I'll put you in there. Go ahead, see if his mic is working. Jesse's going to go see if his mic is working. Look, Casey is raw with the hairiness.
Oh.
Just absolutely like this hairy motherfucker. You
is
know
that
what?
The new flag?
He's a hairy piece of shit. Yeah, it's the new flag, I guess. Yeah.
What is on the left? What the hell? All I know is the rainbow.
What, you didn't hear the Nickelodeon song? You don't know what the fuck is going on here?
Oh,
no, I don't pay attention.
You don't know the...
Oh, no.
Oh, you know, I'm sorry. Well, but we got to do it here.
Oh, no.
Oh,
it's right, everybody.
Oh, God.
You know what? My problem...
And
by the way, my problem is not that even that this is being seen by kids, which is weird, but that's not my problem. My problem is that this person is terrifying. Ready?
It's Pride, everybody!
Like, why are her eyes crossed? That's what I'm...
That's
like,
odd.
What is going on with... Like, why are her eyes crossed? Why did she come up like this? It's Pride, everybody!
I thought, like, that was like a guy just doing a high-pitched voice.
It is. It's a drag queen, right?
Oh, no. Oh,
yeah, it
God.
Is.
But why are her eyes like...
I thought
hey,
it was
everybody.
Luis Alejandro.
Watch, ready?
It's Pride, everybody!
Like,
oh.
What? Like, what? Why are her eyes like that?
I think supposedly supposed to be because it's Pride, you know, disabilities, you know, that type of thing.
No, wait, get the fuck out of here. No, it isn't. Go, no fucking way.
And this was on Nickelodeon, you said?
Well, I mean, it's Pride Month, you know, it's like.
That's the case, then I wouldn't make fun of it. But I really think, like, the makeup's done wrong is what I'm saying.
Oh, well,
I mean, look at the picture of me that you're looking at right now. I look like that right there, but I wouldn't put that on TV.
Oh,
I'd be
like way better.
Yeah, I'd be like, oh, we have to, you know, I'd hit me in the head and make it fixed, you know?
Everybody, every color on the pride flag is a symbol in the sky. Pride. And I'm proud symbol. To be me every time that I see that pride flag waving high. Red seems like
life because living is a gift. Orange means healing, and we have to persist in working to heal the world and healing ourselves. Yellow means sunlight because you gotta shine bright. Green means nature, and we gotta fight to keep our earth up.
By the way, they turned the dislikes off on this video.
Of course.
But you know, I mean, I gotta be honest, you know, any kid's song though with anybody is creepy, right? Even like, remember the Wiggles, you know what I mean? Like that, they weren't, that was creepy. You know, they're all creepy. It's everything kids is, for the most part, on Nickelodeon, I mean, like that is, you know, it's all creepy. So it just makes it even weirder, you know, if you take a person who's a drag queen, you take a drag queen and have her do a kid's song about diversity and colors in the rainbow and stuff, of course it's going to be creepy, because it's like, it's already creepy because it's kids' songs. But then it, so you know, it's one of those things, like, but is it indoctrination? That's the problem that a lot of people think. It's like, why are we talking about any kind of sexual, why are we saying anything about this to kids? Like, we're not doing a song called "People Get Married All the Time," like, no, like, or like, in the bedroom is where people have love, you know, like, we don't do that. So they're trying to teach kids about, I guess, that people are different, but it's a sexuality thing. So it's like, why, I guess. So it's like, it's hard to, I'm trying to figure out like where the balance here is. Well,
I could have sworn that there was a show where they were teaching kids about masturbation.
Oh, that was Tom Green.
Yeah.
Tom
Green,
it puts the bum in the mouth. It puts the bum in the mouth.
I'm being serious. I swear to God. And then he said, and then to check for fucking prostate cancer.
Yeah, but
one kid actually checked his balls for prostate cancer and fucking went to the doctor and he had cancer.
I know. He was teaching people.
Tom Green.
You know what?
Instead, on Nickelodeon, 6-year-olds are like, I just put my dick in my friend John. I don't know why. Oh, doesn't it just fill you with pride knowing straights and it's like.
Doesn't it just fill you with pride, showing who you are on the inside? With that pride flag up high, be true to you.
So creepy when she salutes the flag like it's it's the U.S. flag or a fucking. I mean, I'm down for Pride Month or whatever, or like whatever, you know. I love y'all, gays, whatever you are. I don't care what you are, pansexual. You're good with me. But it's just fun. It's just weird. Like, you're saluting a rainbow flag. It was just really funny that she saluted it. She was like, she did it like a soldier, like the U.S. flag. She was like,
mm-hmm. Yeah.
Like, it was
and
just
the
so
army
creepy. Like,
it's blasphemy. Fuck.
It's just like, I don't know how to feel about it. Like, I'm on the fence. Like,
me too. I don't know.
It's just so. Like, I see the good, but I also still understand. I don't know.
Like, my kids don't give a shit. They see this, they're just going to be like, oh, a song. And they'll be like, that's it. Or my daughter will, actually, my daughter already asked me. She goes, why are all the, what's with all the rainbow flags? Is there, everybody has rainbow flags now. And I was like, oh, well, it's for Pride Month. And she's like, what, like Pride of Colors? And I'm like, no. I'm like, well, it's because, you know how sometimes a guy and a guy get together, or a girl and a girl get married or whatever sometimes? And she's like, yeah, that's okay if they do that. And I'm like, yeah, that's all it is. I'm like, it's just a flag for people to support that's okay. And she's like, oh, okay. I like rainbow colors. Like, but I don't like girls like that. I was like, okay.
See, that's all, like, the way you explained it, that's all they really have to do to
that's
kids.
It.
But they try to go above and beyond. And it's just like.
Yeah, it's weird.
Yeah.
It's like, that's all.
Quick, Jesse's. Thing is not working in this room. We have to go to the other room.
All right, we're all going to go to the other room because Jesse's thing's broken. Doesn't it just fill you up with pride? I've actually had the song in my head for the last week and a half. So they're indoctrinating me because I'm actually singing it. Like, I've been singing it for like a fucking week. It's weird, dude. Doesn't it just fill you up with pride? Like, see, it's in my head. I can't. Yellow
now
people.
You got to fucking get the best theme song in your head now. And that'd be Psycho Dad.
Oh, my God. That's a great point. We need to offset
best
this.
Fucking theme song.
Listen, I'm all for gay pride. You know I love you guys. I know I've said homophobic stuff, but I love you all. Swear to God, I love you. And I'll take care of you all day long. You know I accept you, even if you're whatever you are. It doesn't matter. But
dude, if you got me and Joe drunk enough in the same room, we'd probably blow you.
We'd probably turned out to be bisexual. It's true. Now, I like that white people are on the flag, right? Do we get that little sliver at the far left? Is that for white people? Like, straight white people?
I don't think it is.
What is it? What's it, a cum stain?
Doesn't
it just fill you up with pride?
It's a white voice.
Showing gay vibes on the inside. All you kids can pound and pump your ass full of cum.
I feel the same way, Jesse. I feel the same way.
The white is for rapists.
The white is for rapists. Oh, fuck. You're right. We really need to offset this. We need Psycho Dad, like, right now. Okay. Yeah. Hold on a second. Let me, okay, wait a minute. Let's find the most manliest gif we can find. What's one of the most manliest gifs we can find? I know. Arnold Schwarzenegger pulling out a weapon.
Yeah. All right, yeah.
Get down.
Smoking a cigar.
Get down, command.
Right, pulling out a weapon at the same time. Yeah.
All right, so we gotta pull up Psycho Dad. All right, here we go. Okay, thank God we got this. We're too gay right now.
Best fucking
Christ.
Yes.
Well,
who's the man who kills for fun?
Psycho dad. This reminds me of
a little touch, or so we're told. He killed his wife, motherfucker. Psycho dad.
Thank God, Buffett's song. Jesus,
I feel so much better right now. Well, let's hear Al Bundy do it. Let's hear Al Bundy do it. Here we go. Get it up. Let's go. Yes.
The boy sure is dumb. Who's that white
son?
Who's the man with a hitching gun?
Who's the man
and who kills for fun? Psycho dad.
He loves his son.
Get a Christmas one.
Kills his wife because she weighed a ton. Psycho
Jesse
dad.
Looks so confused right now.
Thank God.
No, I'm not confused. I'm putting pieces together.
There was a Christmas one, too. I remember that he wanted to watch Psycho Dad Christmas, but they wouldn't let him.
Psycho Dad Christmas. Oh, my God, dude. You know what that reminds me of is the thing we always talk about from the movie. From what is it? Fuck, what movie is it that we're always talking about? We always talk about this scene. Oh, it's from Scrooge. Remember Scrooge at the beginning? Santa.
And in China?
No, remember at the beginning of Scrooge? It's like Santa. Santa's under attack. And wicked funny, dude. They're like, Ed Reims is like fucking.
Oh, yeah.
It's funny, dude. It was years. I never knew that scene existed. Because I had like a taped version of it, and it always skipped that part, and then it started the tape.
Oh
right
my
after.
God!
So I didn't realize till way later. I was like, "What?"
Oh, here
what
it is.
What?
That's funny, dude.
Here
I
it is.
That the tank.
This is great.
Guns.
Santa, is there a back way out of this place?
Of course there is, Lee. But this is one Santa that's going out the front door.
It's Lee Majors. Remember, it's Lee.
No matter a hill of beans, what happens to me? The world couldn't afford it if anything happened to you. Now you stay put.
Oh, that's very nice of you, Lee. And Lee, you've been a real good boy this year.
Yes, you sure have.
7 o'clock. Psycho sees Santa's workshop. Eat this.
Yeah.
And only Lee Majors can stop him.
Only Lee Majors
At
can
7
stop.
O'clock, Psycho sees Santa's village, and only one man can stop them.
Oh,
Lee Majors.
Point.
Dude, I, I love 90s movies like that shit.
Yeah, dude.
Like,
oh, yeah.
So much
Scrooge was a goddamn
so
classic.
Much violence and tits everywhere.
Yeah, and not only that, but they're actually like spoofing the real movies were like that. So it was like they're like making they're being more ridiculous, obviously, but it's like they were kind of like that. Like especially movies that were like underground more, like the ones that like Red Letter Media always reviews.
Mm-hmm.
It's like, dude, that shit, there was tons of those type of movies. Like the White
like
House.
Miami Connection.
Yes. Yeah. And shit like that, where it was just over the top gun violence everywhere. Shit's going crazy.
Dude, Miami Connection was about gun violence, cocaine, and a band that were ninjas at night.
Whoa. Oh.
A rock band that was ninjas at night. Ninjas. Not
the other one.
Probably one of the great shittiest movies I've ever seen in my life.
Have to say that I owe another shot. Here's to you, D. Wells, for the $100. Luis Antonio Alejandro. Luis Antonio Alejandro, say pussy.
Pussy.
Luis, say pussy.
Say you're a pussy.
All right.
I guess he's dead.
I guess he's gay. Okay, here we go.
He's fucking dead.
Doesn't it just fill you with the pride?
Plus is equal, and black and brown represent the
goddamn.
Oh, my goodness.
Doesn't it just fill you with pride?
Joe, you got to cover this.
Those girls hate.
How do we... could I get the... Could somebody get me the instrumental to this? Like,
Joe's
is that a Nickelodeon theme song? What is that?
It is.
Showing who you are on the inside.
Oh, dude, my God.
This is bad that I can even just bob my head to it for no godly reason. It's so frustrating.
When she's running in place like this, like her ass is being fucked, and she's running in place like, fill you up with pride. Like, that's the weirdest part to me. I mean, listen. I like it.
I think I'll listen to the instrumental, but that's it.
Yeah. Well, let's see if I could get one. I could say, I would like to fill you up with cum. I could change it. I could fill you up with cum.
With hate. Wait, let's do that.
Conservative parents are mad. I mean, I don't know. I thought he had one, Jesse. I swear to God he did.
If he doesn't, he should.
Yeah, that's true.
Honestly.
I don't know why he would. You know why he might not have is because he used to be a member.
Mm.
And I used to be like, I don't want to take away his green. It looks so cool.
Oh, no, yeah. Give him the blue. Trust me, it's better.
Well, probably he can probably figure them all out like before. Like,
well, no,
shit.
The four people I just told you are. They all got it, or three, whatever.
I don't know why. I explain why Ezvi doesn't have it, though. I swear. You know what it is? It's from when I reset the wrenches. That's why.
Maybe, but definitely throw Randy one, too. Like, he fucking... It's funny, him and Ed are getting so fast, they're getting them before I do. Like, that's what's showing. I'm like, all right. Huh. I guess I could kick back a little.
Ezvi, how's Japan tonight, brother? White boy's never going to beat us in a fight, says Devante.
Oh, hey,
did you see what Jake Paul did to Nate Robinson? I mean, what are you talking about?
Well,
usually you pick against the white guy usually, though, Devontae. You're right about
I'll
that.
Take the victory.
I'm not even that drunk. I've only had four shots. I'm only on shot number four.
I'm on, this is number five and six.
There you go, baby. Shout out to D. Wells. She dropped a hundy earlier. That's... Joe, you're right about the riots. Just got back from Myrtle Beach and heard a crazy story.
Ooh.
What does that mean? It's going down at Myrtle Beach, man.
Myrtle sounds like Archie's wife's sister or something.
Yeah. Well, jeez, Myrtle. Go fucking murder yourself, Myrtle.
Me and Myrtle used to rub clams, Archie.
You remember? Archie! Archie, what were you doing upstairs, Archie? You cheated on me, didn't you?
Really?
No.
I mean, if it wasn't my fault, she pulled her clothes off in front of me. You know I can't stop.
You're supposed to stop, Archie. We're married, Archie.
Yeah, we are married, but her clam was out. I don't know, bro.
No, my God, dude. I love it.
You think
can you imagine
funny?
If she tells Archie, like, she's been fucking the Jefferson? Or the,
well, I have something to tell you, Archie. I've been fucking the Jeffersons, Archie, for 3 months. The chocolate ones?
What is happening?
Yes, Archie, the black ones. Oh God! Are you saying are you saying you're going interracial? Jeez, Edith, technically that means I've fornicated with a. Oh no! Come on, Archie! I don't even know, dude. I don't know.
We need a gunshot at the end of that.
I'm sorry. I don't know what we're doing, dude.
I love that. I don't know what you just said. Jungle Honey or something, but.
I'm just imagining.
It's even funnier, like, when you're confused what's happening. And it's just going.
Dude, that was great. No, he fucking nailed it. Like, he fucking killed it. I love it. What did you say? You go, I couldn't help it as a man. You're supposed to stop, Archie. But her clam was out.
I freaking love being clueless.
You do know All in the Family, right?
Oh, he probably doesn't. He probably doesn't know what we're doing.
You as a human being, must watch All in the Family.
Oh, my God, dude. It was this show on in, like, the 60s and 70s. Archie Bunker.
Heard anything you'll watch now, I'll tell you.
It's like, so basically, it was on reruns in the 80s and early mid-90s, and it went off the air really for the most part. But it was on reruns in the 80s and 90s.
It was still hot as a rerun thing,
but he would say words on TV that you wouldn't believe now. And he'd be like, know what they're like, Edith? You know what them, he would say that shit on fucking the show. Like, and stuff.
When it was great, because it wasn't just white, Mr. Jefferson come over, he's just as bad as Archie. So, like, you got the black hate and the white. It was so fun. Like, they just misunderstood each other, and it was so funny. It wasn't even hate. It was just misunderstanding.
Yeah, it was a funny show. And, like, you know, Jefferson. The Jeffersons, yeah, they'd hit it back. Like, you wouldn't know.
Oh, it was just prejudice, Edith. No big deal.
Yeah, it was like everybody was talking shit, dude. It was. But, like, the opening. Dude, this is the opening. But listen to Edith's voice as she sings the opening with Archie. It's very fucking crazy. You've probably seen a picture of these guys before. At least Cody, maybe. I don't know. This is
Family Guy did this probably. Shit.
Yeah, Family Guy is basically like a spoofiness of it, in a way.
Yeah. Very true. Luis, Todd.
That's Luis singing.
And I mean, this is basically, now tell me, is Girls Were Girls and Men Were Men, is that a shot at homosexuality?
Yeah, yeah, absolutely. Oh,
okay.
Yeah, listen to that line. Listen to that line. Listen, ready?
Well, wait, we knew that.
Yeah, but you know what? He's a flamer for singing this song. Listen to the Girls and Men Were Men. Mister, we could use a man like Herbert Hoover again. It's basically like, we're conservatives. It should be called
this. We don't need no welfare checks or some shit.
Yeah,
stuff.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
Everybody,
oh my God.
Everybody pulled his weight.
Was that Luis Alejandro?
Yeah, dude. Luis is singing
that. That is great.
Dude,
now that you pulled up the image of those two. I've seen that.
You had to have. Everybody's seen it at least
I've
once.
I've seen a melted
if
clam.
If you haven't watched it, though, it's worth every bit.
There was a little skit
so
of
good.
Them. There was a little skit of them I saw a while back.
Uh-huh.
It was like of something they're trying to do a commercial or some shit. I don't know. It was really
Did you ever see The Wolf of Wall Street?
They're great.
Yes.
You know the Wolf of Wall Street's dad in that movie?
Yeah.
You know the guy that plays his
dad? Rob Reiner.
That's Rob Reiner, and he's... The son, the son in All in the Family, so he's
Meathead.
In that show.
Yeah, Meathead.
He was Meathead. He was like the liberal hippie who was married to his daughter, who would be
and they were both like the hippies, like dad is a gangster. We all love each other. Fuck that shit. No, or whatever. Right. Like,
Yeah, but
dude, when they pulled out a gun in that one episode, that shit got fucking crazy.
Yeah,
in his house,
they had some serious racial shit.
Honestly,
some fucking,
you know what though, Garguts?
Dude, I gotta,
if you
abusive shit,
if you yeah. watch the show, it's way relatable now. If you watch the show, because like Meathead will be like, they got to do something about the gun control. Oh, we don't need no gun control, Meathead. You need purse control is what you need. You know, and like they would fight and you'd be like, oh, I you can identify with it because that same stuff goes on right now.
Timeless.
It's timeless. Yeah.
It's timeless. Absolutely.
The liberal who wants to save
almost,
the world.
It's timeless and almost canceled.
Yeah, that's true.
Like I said, everything repeats every 20 years. So
yeah,
dude, Sean Harrington in the chat has a good point. He goes, yes, Archie was against gays, but the best part of the show was after saying some bigoted stuff, he would often get his comeuppance towards the end of the episode. Yeah, there was always a little, or he'd learn a little more, but he'd
either
still,
that's the
still
thing
wake
is,
up hating motherfuckers.
That's the thing is, he would either learn something or he would have it come back in his face. And Archie's the type of guy that like by the end of the show, you know what I mean? And they did this in a few episodes, and I can't specifically think the episodes, but put it this way. But it's something like this. Like there's a guy in the laundry place, right? There'd be a guy in the laundry place, and some guy would come in, and the guy was obviously gay or whatever. And Archie would probably make fun of him, be like, "Look at this fucking fairy." And then some other guy would be like, "Hey, homo." Like, and he'd be like, How about you go back to whatever the fuck?" But then even though Archie was like this guy who didn't understand it and didn't really like it and he was kind of a bigot, he would be the guy to be like, hey, get the hell, you know, he'd be the one that would stick up for him if it really came down to it. Because he wouldn't, you know what I mean? Yeah. Like, it's sort of like one of those things where it's one of those, you know, now they just call the show racist or whatever, but it's like, it really had,
that's ridiculous.
It had a
if
message.
Anything, those kind of shows, and you brought it up with Apu before, where these shows brought us all together. That's what they really, really did.
Yeah,
I mean, when you think about it, right? Like, you understood when you went into a fucking 7-Eleven that the dude, like, you understood, you just, I don't know, because you saw Apu in The Simpsons, you didn't trip, like, on things so much. Same thing with, you saw that Archie was one way and, like, the Jefferson dude was the other. You saw that, like, it wasn't, you know what I mean? It wasn't all one-sided, I guess I could say.
Right.
Like, it really did, like, bring everybody together. Now, diversity does nothing but divide. That's all that this diversity crap is all about, is
because it
fills
you up,
dividing you up until
pride.
You hate everybody. They want you to hate every last layer that makes you you and anybody else them. That's the whole fucking diversity bullshit.
That's the end of politics. It just sucks because that show sounds like it's hilarious, right? And then now,
no, it's great. You can still get it.
It just like sucks nowadays. Now we have that one sitcom that's like that.
Yeah.
It's that girl actor playing the boy, whatever, the teenager that you guys went over a while
ago.
Oh, yeah. Never. Like, it's,
you know,
shit like that. That's just so.
Wait.
Did you guys
like
Modern Family?
You know
that... Go ahead.
No, I was going to say, there was actually the girl who played Bobby Hill in fucking King of the Hill. She was in Red Fox's old show, and they thought that she was a guy until like 4 weeks of filming into it. They were like, you're a chick?
What?
She passed for a guy. So they made a
you're
whole.
A dame?
About her revealing her gender to Red Fox. They wrote it around that incident, and they kicked her out of the show.
If you can act, you can act, man. I mean, that's the thing. Like, I don't mind if anybody plays whoever the fuck, you know. I mean, Albert Wesker is about to be a black guy now. Resident Evil.
Oh yeah.
Everybody's mad about
actually,
that.
The actor that's playing as him, I actually like. He's a pretty good actor, but it's just that why are they picking him to be, you know?
I
liked him in John Wick.
It's not that big a deal to me, but I've actually been, dude. I had two of my, and this is on Twitter. I have two of my liberal, I have two liberal, fairly liberal black friends on Twitter. Two fairly liberal black friends who went, I don't normally care that much about this stuff, but this is stupid. Why are they doing this? And they're talking about Wesker, and I went, really? You're mad about Wesker of all the things? And they're like, yeah, I don't know why. This just doesn't need, it should be, this is what he's always looked like. I don't like it. So, I mean, I don't know. Someone tried hijacking a plane in LA. Did you guys see this? Someone tried hijacking a plane in LA. Is this real?
No.
Hold on a minute. We got breaking news coming in from Rick.
Dude, Awandi was coming to see me.
Holy shit.
Oh, man. Damn.
Surprise blown, huh?
What is this?
You ready?
Get out of the cockpit. Where is everybody? Get in there. It's midnight, I know, but get in there. Wake up. Wake up. Whoa. Use the gun.
Everybody just standing around, dude. I would have got up, fucking.
I think they dragged him out.
And then that's it.
Looks like they might have dragged him out. Holy shit.
The plane.
Dude, I'd beat the shit. You'd beat the shit out of someone. If you saw someone trying to, like, get on the plane like that or whatever, dude, you'd be like, yo, we're kicking your ass, bro. Because you don't know what else would they be there for, unless they were drunk or something. I mean,
dude,
probably.
I mean, shit. I drank so much on the plane. On the plane. Before I got on the plane.
Say the plane. Go ahead.
You fucking.
Goddamn Rice-A-Roni.
Had, like.
No, I'm sorry. I'm getting
stomach problems. When I was in the restroom, dude, I was just like, Jesus Christ. I'm like 2 hours away from fucking Texas. I can't have a medical emergency right now. So I just fucking, you know, you gotta, people just fucking, they freak out on the fucking plane. You just gotta fucking just calm down, chill the fuck out.
Shark,
you'll be good.
You must have a crazy ass life. You have a story for almost everything. It's crazy.
He does.
Holy shit.
Right. He's done it all.
Well, I did come from Vegas the other, like, what, a week ago, a month ago.
I mean,
nigga, fucking 6 months ago. Think about it. Don't get all.
Garguts has no kids. He's fucking like my age. All he's done in his life is awesome shit.
Oh yeah, that's I'm like
live my life, man.
Oh, he's a liar too. He's a big liar, but
that too. I'm a big fat liar. Yeah,
he's also a liar.
you are.
Yeah, because all I do is just sit my ass right here and fucking talk to you guys.
He just makes up stuff. Every second he makes things up.
Well, we all just sit here. This is what we do. Even when we're off air, this is what we're doing. We just sit here together. None of us have a life. Right?
No, just, camera's always on.
I don't even change my
silence until the showtime for the next show.
Why don't you change your fucking pants? How about that?
I didn't even change my pants, my consolcios, nothing.
Oh, I thought you said change his panties. I'm like, he's wearing panties? Oh.
No, I fucking... I changed my pants. God damn, I fucking changed my pants.
What color underwear you got?
Listen, never change your pants when I come in you, okay? Always.
Yeah, take them off. Don't change them.
I got clear underwear right now.
Ooh, clear what underwear.
Fuck?
We're a Mexican themed one. Mexican color.
Doesn't it just fill you with
free balling? Is that what you were saying? Like, that's what you're doing, Gark?
And I'm free. Oh, yeah.
Dude, I swear to God, I want to put a fence up just because, like, I live in a pretty rural area.
Oh, I know,
like,
why you want to put a fence up.
I'm going to put a fence up and just walk around naked, watering the cactuses.
That's not a bad idea.
No, for real, though, dude. Cactus, right? Like, dude, I love it, man. You get so much fucking...
You ever see people, like, they're like, naked. They do, like, survival in the desert, and they fucking cut open cactus, and they fucking eat inside of it? Mm. It's fucking crazy.
I mean, it's got, it's filled with a lot of water and I mean, that'd be a bitch, though. Pick through that shit. Eesh.
You get a bamboo straw.
To eat it. What?
Bamboo straw.
Get a bamboo straw.
Some
right?
bamboo Suck straw? Oh, my God.
Western U.S. God, city dubbed bullseye of global warming. Western U.S. city.
Gin and juice.
The wrestlers?
Gin and juice the wrestlers? No, I wish.
No, gin and juice time, I guess, raw man. Oh, cheers, motherfucker.
Oh, Twink. Excuse me, shit.
You want to have a cheers?
Gin and juice.
Yo, Joe, around that time with All in the Family and everything, do you remember watching Mama's House?
Yeah.
Was it called Mama's House?
Mama's House.
Man, I watched Good Times.
Remember the opening? She's like vacuum cleaning the fish tank?
Yeah.
Ooh. What a dumbass.
Yeah, I used to watch that show all the time. Because it was Carol Burnett, and Carol Burnett's from, like, here.
Oh, wait. I don't even think I knew that was her.
Oh, wow.
I didn't know that was her. What, is she wearing a wig and everything?
Yes, they made her look old.
Oh, my God. I didn't know that was Carol Burnett.
That's fucking hilarious. She's awesome. I love Carol Burnett. Noises Off, man. I love that movie. Fucking funny.
No, I'm gonna lie, right? I'm gonna lie because I have a story for that.
Yeah, I met her. No. And she fucked me.
No. My great grandma used to babysit her when she was a kid.
Here we go.
That's how I fucking knew about that whole.
And my great grandmother used to babysit her. She called her a little gringo. It was amazing. No, how the hell did? Wait, was she raised out there? Where was your grandmother? Were you guys in California, Texas, or what?
No, they're in Texas. They just lived downtown. Oh, and like a block away from each other. So damn. her house is preserved, not far from where my great grandma's house was.
Holy shit!
Probably down the street. It's crazy.
That is crazy. Sorry, yeah.
I've been in her house, and it's like a museum. You go in there, and they have all this shit now in there.
I mean, she's still alive.
Mm-hmm.
Carol Burnett is still alive right now.
Yep.
Wow. She's just not doing
anything. So is dude. I was looking at Iron Sheik. That motherfucker's 79, still kicking. Jesus.
I want this place shining like the Chrysler Building. Sorry.
Oh no! Hey. Get the fuck out of my Chrysler.
Get down and Annie. Get over here and shine my pussy.
Oh,
get
no.
the sponge.
Dude, that's the easiest thing in the world.
Annie,
talk dirty, dear.
Get the sponge.
Oh, it's Vicky Lawrence. Right up. I'm a jackass. Vicky Lawrence. That's who it was. Because Vicky Lawrence was her fucking. Yeah, it was the spinoff of Carabinette. Vicky Lawrence.
Oh.
See, Joe, you were right.
I know. See,
I remember
Carabinette. Listen to the Mexican.
Holy shit. You know I think Leah's going to look like her when she's 80.
Oh, I thought you said Leah was going to come on the show. I was excited for
I'm
half,
looking at
half
the fucking
a second
shit right here.
No, but I think Leah might start looking like Carol Burnett when she's like 90. When Leah turns 90, she's going to look like Carol Burnett.
All right. Oh. Well.
Doesn't it just fill you up with pride? Sorry.
Yeah, but she's not going to. I don't see Leah going for the plastic surgery deal like this broad.
You know, Carol Burnett is starting. Carol Burnett's starting to look like a camel.
She's starting
to look like a camel.
Yeah. Oh no, like the old Thirst Busters.
Yeah.
Holy shit. Oh my god.
How many
dude.
Humps do you think she's got?
Oh.
No, I love
she's
Kim.
Only
I
got
love
one her. Or two humps left in her, I think it does. You know.
I think that's long gone, Jesse. I don't think that's even.
Oh my god.
She's a spitter though, just like the camel.
Oh god damn.
What the fuck is that?
That's her last hump right there.
Wait a minute. Hey, Cody, tell your girlfriend to quiet down. We're
that's her last hump
here.
Right there. The last. Carol Burnett. Oh, my God.
What'd
dude,
you
that's,
say?
Oh
say,
that's going to be the new.
Get out of the fucking way.
That's going to be the new episode.
Yeah, I did. And he did. He got out of the way when it was. Oh, my God. You're right. She was like bending over or whatever. I'm like, Cody, get out of the way.
On the next move. On the next Star Trek, The Sex Generation, Carol Burnett and the Last Hump. But will Worf insert his big Klingon dick into Carol Burnett's asshole?
Oh,
on
Betty
the next
White was on that show?
Star Trek, The Sex Generation.
Huh.
Wow, can't wait for that to come out. It's going to be good.
Wait, Gargus, was Betty White on that show you were talking about?
She was on everything.
No, but somebody and was everyone. Saying in the chat that Betty White was on that show as well. And
she's going to be on too? Ladies and gentlemen. On the next episode of Star Trek, The Sex Generation, Betty White guest stars. But it's not going to go very well because Captain Picard is going to rape her. That's right. Wait, or does he? Or is it an alien specter that boards the Star Trek Enterprise that takes Captain Picard's form and inserts his alien dick into Betty White? Find out if she gets raped and if they find out who did it on the next episode of Star Trek, The Sex Generation. Captain, something has penetrated the shields. I want the shields back, Commander. Oh, something's in me. Oh! Intruder alert, red alert. On the next Star Trek, The Sex Generation. It's going to be an unbelievable episode next week. I can't wait for that one. That's going to be great. I love that they've sort of brought back Star Trek with this sort of sexy spinoff. I like it. It's like the old characters come back, but with a flair. So good. Sorry. Lost my mind.
Yeah, that's cool.
That's okay. Yeah.
It's all right. The donations, we paused or what? Hey, if you guys got donations, now's the time to do them and tell us what you want me to do. I got, I've taken a few shots here for D. Welsh. I may take a few more. Hell, I may even smoke up if something weird happens. And Jesse, yes. Jesse, you've been a bad boy. Yes. Where's Luis Antonio Alejandro? Is he still here?
Or
is he
just sitting there? I'm always bad. Oh.
I'm out of
good.
Here, Joe.
Ah. He is videotaping us as we speak with binoculars attached. I don't know why.
That sounds like Patty White.
Luis, go rape a doll.
Shit. He probably is already.
Yeah, that's right.
You become a shit bum.
Randy Viper.
Ooh, Raggedy
I
Ann.
Want that biddy biddy bum bum biddy biddy bum bum.
Yeah, I mean, bum, bum.
Oh,
who, I mean, who wouldn't want that biddy biddy bum biddy biddy bunghole? I mean,
oh shit.
Let's see if this wakes up Luis Antonio Alejandro.
Watch him show up on camera.
He wakes up as if he's dreaming about himself, yelling at himself. Oh,
mi corazón.
You become a shit bomb.
A shit bomb.
Joe, bring back the sweet, sweet coconutty Malibu.
I have, you know what?
Oh, well, he's, what? Oh boy.
I haven't been to the liquor store. I have not gone to the liquor store in 3 months. And that's why I don't have any Malibu. Whoa. I'm literally just drinking what's
left.
Well,
dude, how does, how have you been doing when you drink, like Jameson and other shit? Like, is it chill? Like, you're not like getting the
as long as
acidy
I,
shit?
As long as I drink a little water, I'm fine. Drink a little water.
There you go.
It's great, man. I would say my new favorite drink besides Malibu is now Jameson. Jameson and Malibu is now my drink.
It's good. I'm into it, dude. I'm digging all whiskeys these days, but I really do. I like Jameson. It fits any night, like any mood. It works well.
My only thing is that, you know, I just haven't, you know, I've obviously been trying to watch money and stuff like that. So I haven't gone to the liquor store in like 3 months. So I'm just drinking literally.
Don't you have an outlet? Like, where you can get it cheap, I mean. Well, like, where you really like $30 for 2 liters.
Yeah, I mean, I can go get a whole bottle for $9 or some shit. But like, point is, I don't need to. My point is, what I'm doing is I'm drinking everything I have in the house. Like everything that's left in the house. Yeah, I go through all that first before I go back to a liquor store.
Dude, be careful though, man. I did that and I fucking ended up drinking a. Oh my
shit,
god, it's that Italian shit that's made by Sambuca.
You become
gross.
Oh, I got a handle.
Wake up, Luis. We need to hear your stories.
Oh, he's asleep.
You know what?
Wait, his stories never go anywhere.
How much you want to bet that in like out of nowhere in like 20 minutes, all of a sudden he's going to come on and be like, ah! And we're going to be like, what the hell? He's going to be like,
Dash can suck my dong.
I have my microphone muted the whole time. Like, that's what he's going to come on.
Oh, yeah, something, yeah.
The one story, Jesse had to push him along through the story because he just kept stopping and getting off track.
I will
about
push
to, like,
him
park
off a cliff.
Yes.
That girl he met online, whatever he was.
God bless him and her and the internet connection that made it happen.
Right. C-Man in the Discord. Yeah.
I'm pouring another drink. Fuck Luis.
Go read that Garguts in the Discord.
Oh, boy.
C-Man goes, Garguts can't help himself, can he? He just has to lie. It causes him physical anguish if he doesn't feed some bullshit story.
Wow.
Whoa, nice. You would really do that?
Well, nice. Not... I mean, there was another guy that did it worse and that more fit the bill, but...
Who's that?
Hey, you know. I'm sorry. I'm sorry
it's
I have
just,
a
you know,
fucking
your favorite
light
bright friend.
Sorry, I have a life.
Seaman?
Sorry, I went through a lot of shit.
No, it's somebody who uses light brights for a room.
Light bright, turn up.
Nobody can put this together?
I know.
You know what
about.
I'm saying, Garguts.
I know what you're talking about now.
Fucking, it's your antagonist.
It's your arch nemesis, I think he's talking about.
Mm.
What?
Yes.
I have no such thing.
Well, hey, good luck with that.
Well,
people like
Mister,
to
it's not late, you're late.
People just
no
shit.
People just like to talk shit, but I don't give
they
a
do.
Fuck.
They love it.
I never did. And it gets to them. But I don't care.
I just
I gotta tell you right now. It's your Mose buddy. Blaze. You Mose Blaze, baby. What's up, Mose Blaze?
Ooh, dude, what's
oh,
up?
Oh shit, Moss. I haven't heard from you in a while.
Yep.
Jesse,
what's up, dude?
You're alive. I'm glad you're alive, brother.
Never die, sir. Never.
Never. Hey, Jesse, have you ever wondered how your life would be different if that nurse weren't fucked up on you?
Jesus.
Yeah, I mean, it would have been better in a lot of ways, but I'd never have met you crazy fucks, I'll say that.
Yeah, I was
I've been living too much of life to do that.
Wouldn't you like to breastfeed her?
You know?
I'd like to breastfeed her. Like, just breastfeed
her.
No,
I just hope her... I hope her kid's fucked up, though.
Oh!
She was pregnant at the time, so it serves her right and him for being there. Yeah, you don't do that.
Well, in that case...
Far in a pregnancy, you don't do your nurse job.
We can only hope that he was stillborn.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Well, no, that would be better because, I mean, wishing the torture of life, you know, it'd been better.
I just want him dead.
Oh, well, see, there you go. So stillborn.
He'll never go through what I've gone through. So, like, I might as well just, I hope she suffers because he died early.
Or her pussy.
Yeah, it's a mother. She deserves it. She fucked up my life and my mom's. She deserves that. Kidding, dude. I really don't wish those kind of things. And I don't even think about those kind of things like that. I mean, if anything, I try and figure out how to get out of this fucked up hole I'm in.
Because
I really should be on hospice, but they won't. Unless I'm going to die in another 5 months, they will never help me. I have to already be so dead that I'm like, well, what's the point? I'll just fucking live my life to the fullest for the next 5 months then. Mm. And I'll die the real way.
Yeah.
Like, so what's the point? Right, you know? I mean, I'm not going to...
Yeah, I get you.
I take enough ibuprofen to kill most fucking people. I kill an elephant with the fucking
Yeah, we've talked about this. The amount that you take, you would think your stomach would be just shithole.
And I'm taking it with alcohol. What do you do, you know?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
No, yeah, I'm taking 3,000 milligrams ibuprofen a day, and that's just the ibuprofen.
Oh, I see the...
I'm surprised you're not on a second liver like Larry Funk.
No, I'll probably be on a third kidney soon. No, it's the kidneys you have to worry about because, you know, ADHD meds,
well,
fucking,
stomach lining too. It'll make
ibuprofen.
Your stomach
fuck that. That's already a Pisces Virgo thing. If that was going to hit me, that would have happened a long time ago. I've obviously got the organs. I might be fucked up everywhere else, but if one place is right, it's the organs. My organs handle this shit so well.
Right.
Like, I've even gotten to a point where I don't have to... Fuck. Yeah, I might be. I don't know. Check my ID. Fuck that.
I fucked the Yeti. So...
If they can use them, take them. I don't give a shit.
Yeah, I was going to say, can even take them.
Well, they could. Like, I don't have cancer. I don't have any, like, my bones were fucked up. Like, a lot of things were fucked up, but my organs are pretty good, you know? I mean, you're right, though, about, like, the stomach lining. They told me years ago, my fucking doctor that started giving me ibuprofen, he goes, you know, most of the people I see now in their 80s are, they have kidney failure and they're all on dialysis because of ibuprofen. So I'm going to let you know that before I give you this. Like, and it's like, all right, well, that's the way it is. So.
Yeah.
What are you going to do?
What do you think the damage?
Said, oh, don't take ibuprofen because of COVID. I laughed.
What do you think the kidney damage is equal to? Like, let's pretend like, you know, like a long long night of drinking alcohol is the same, or would you say like the two pills are way worse?
They're diuretics, uppers, caffeine, things like that tear your kidneys apart. Ibuprofen. So I take ibuprofen. I drink a pot of coffee a day. I take stuff for ADHD.
Wait, but you think caffeine?
I mean, it's all kidney killers. My liver's probably okay.
You think caffeine's killing your kidneys though?
Caffeine does hurt your kidneys if you drink a lot of it. If you take caffeine pills, that will turn your kidneys into goddamn grapes. Or no, raisins, rather.
But yet it counteracts the fattiness of a liver, though. So it's like you want to do... So you'd rather drink black coffee... Well, I'm sorry, it doesn't, but coffee does. So you want to drink coffee without caffeine in it, is really what the answer is.
Oh, like decaf, yeah. Right. I'll probably switch to that at some point. But the fucked up thing is, like, because I'm in pain all the time, I need something to happen up here. Like, I'm not like most people who are lazy as fuck. They don't get off their ass. But hey, if you go do a workout or run, you might feel better. I can't do those things. So I have to have something to spark, physiology has to spark somehow between your brain, your mind, your body.
Because sparking biology would be coming.
Well, like, I mean, think about it. If all you had naturally coming through your body in pain and like your mind and your brain is cortisol, like stress and pain chemicals, that's all you get to feel all the time. You're going to need coffee or something to counteract that shit.
I just wanted to take a quick second to be a little somber here and say To Ryan Romano, man, that I'm sorry about your father. I just saw on Twitter. His father just died on Wednesday. I don't know, man. He's got a big tweet out there. Go give him some love. Sorry to Ryan Romano, man. Rest in peace to your dad. We love you, brother. I hope you're okay.
Yeah.
Sorry, dude. That's awful.
Man.
Love Ryan so much, man. He's such a sweetheart, this guy.
Dude, is that
he's usually in chat.
Who is that in the chat? Is he the same name in the chat when he's in here?
Yeah.
Yeah, usually.
Okay. I haven't seen him tonight then, okay.
Yeah.
I'll see that guy in these chats, Drew's chats, and then I'll see him in Texas wrestling chats because
he's super into Thunder Rosa and everybody out there. Yeah.
So today they went live and I was just like, wow, he's not in the chat today. That's kind of odd.
Well, dude, he probably isn't having in Discord, but like whatever, dude, you ever need someone to talk to, you let me know, man.
Yeah, he's getting a lot of love on Twitter, but that sucks, bro. He lost his dad. What the fuck?
It does.
That's crazy. He posts usually.
Never
like
a right
that.
Time to lose your dad or your mom or anybody like that, you know?
I think it was a good time when my dad died when I was 8, because I think I figured out, you know, fuck men.
Well,
no, I'm just kidding.
You know, it weirdly worked out for you, but that's, well, it really did work out for you, but like, that's because of who you are. Like, you were strong enough to push forward. Like, I don't think you would be, we would never have been here, right? It's like me with the pain thing, right? With the nurse.
Right,
if that didn't happen to you, even if all this shit happened to me, we wouldn't be here right now without you going through what you went through, I going what I went through. Garga, it's whoever. It's
dude,
fucking insane, right?
Dude, this guy just had his DoorDash robbed. Look at this.
Fuck.
This
guy. You're getting that shit on your feed because of Drew, aren't you? That happened to me.
No, I mean, well, yeah, maybe. But no.
I got so many DoorDash fucking video things.
Look at this.
I was looking at his shit.
Well, I mean, this guy delivers DoorDash, takes a picture, walks away. And now, coming into frame in like 2 seconds up here is this guy in an orange shirt. Did you ever think in 2021 you'd see a black guy deliver food to a white person and then a white guy come and steal it? I mean, hilarious.
Yeah. Why not?
Well,
wow, he didn't. Wait, dude, was that like literally seconds after?
He must have saw it get dropped off. He was like, oh, let me just look.
They need to knock on the door or fucking... You know what I'm saying? Knock on the door. He didn't even knock on the door. He just fucking said, I'm going to take a
picture. No, he didn't. You should do that. Yeah, you should hit the bell, do the door. Don't just text
people. There's a thing in the app where it's like you can choose for them to ring or not.
Yeah.
Or they just drop it off.
Okay.
But usually you get a text update, though, that it's delivered.
Wait, so these people obviously had fucking security cams. So what?
You're right.
A lot of good that did.
I can't believe that.
They turn the lights. Like,
fucking
is he still
Christ,
in our
dude! Don't be. Oh my God, you are such a pathetic piece of shit. You know that?
Yeah. Holy shit.
Like, yo. I'm gonna just say right now. Like, I mean, I'll do a joke about his dad right now, and I will fucking be nothing like your fucking. You don't even fucking reach a curb. Your fucking height is non-existent. You fucking pathetic piece of deplorable shit.
I mean,
Jesus Christ. Yeah, like, damn. If you're going to fucking troll, be smart about it. Show that you have a fucking wrinkle in your brain.
A wrinkle in your brain?
Dude, I don't care that you even went... Like, you could have gone after is that like the whole thing and been funny about it. It could work. And maybe it doesn't work. But that you're just fucking easy peasy piece of shit. You should fucking be killed.
You could have just said, like, hey, go get a custom from Rosa or
something.
Or
get cancer and suffer and die. I don't know. Your whole family should die in front of you before you... You piece of shit.
What you should have done was left the name up so like hundreds of people could report it. That's it.
No, I'll unhide it right now. They can have them.
Yeah, just go back up and just mask that one. And they'll get rid of that.
Fucking report this dude until he is fucking, he gets
you're gonna
do it. Fuck it. Allegedly.
No. Doesn't it just fill you up with pride? Yeah, I was at New England All-Star Wrestling tonight, yeah. I was there tonight. Yo,
There's a.
Here, I'll give you a minute to report. As I said, I'm getting rid of him.
That's a good idea.
I already reported it.
A big, you know, because if like 50 people do it, they go away quicker. Like all their shit goes away.
And then Google comes in here quicker, and they fucking see the shit, and then they and they start doing their stuff.
What were you gonna say now?
Yeah.
Oh, I was gonna say there's a thing going on Twitter called hashtag Fear the Gay Agenda. I guess it's some wrestling event that was going on.
So only gays could wrestle.
Yeah.
I don't know. It just looked like somebody got slammed through a table while there was a little fire
that's
going.
That's
in what way though?
Was it Effie?
Yeah.
Wait a minute. If there was a dildo suction cupped up to the table and they went through it, then it's gay.
Oh, God. Imagine that.
But this doesn't sound very gay. This is just a spot, you know?
Dildo on a pole match.
Dildo. Ooh.
You know what? I'm not going to stem on this reel too long, but for just a quick second, I wanted to say, for all the people who are gamers out there, because I know that a lot of, like, some of you guys, a few of you, I would say there's like 15 or 20 of you out there to play Diablo 3 and the new season, they're grabbing old items from Diablo 2 and they're putting them in this season so you can find them and use them.
Oh shit!
With passives and stuff. So I'm pretty hard. Like I'm pretty bonerific.
Did they drop a list of what items?
There's a list, yeah.
So is it a new game or can you transfer over?
No, it's just all it is like it's just items in the new season that are you can find. It's gonna be fun to find.
Oh, okay.
Pretty much.
Fucking yeah, hell yeah.
I'm hoping for the fucking lightsaber sword or whatever the fuck from 2. That was sick. They
was
bring
like
that
a,
back.
I thought it was going to be like a new Diablo. It wouldn't it be
no,
sick
no, no. This
new,
is
like
just
new
the new
Diablo, and then you can transfer everything that you've had from the old Diablo.
No, this
Diablo.
Is just the new season.
Wait, what?
No, every season is different, and this season what they're doing is they're introducing these 22 all right. new weapons as well.
Has anybody played around with the I heard they re-released Diablo 2 or something, or they did something with it? Anybody mess with that?
Oh yeah, no, Resurrected's coming out. Resurrected's coming out by the end of the year. Remastered.
Oh dude, I will, if you're down to play that shit, I'm down.
I already bought it. I bought it a year ago.
I can't even really get into 3, but I can get into 2. I would rather they release a whole nother fucking whatever expansion. Well, I guess that's what they're doing, right? But I'm down. I am, dude, I'll go buy it too. Fuck it. Let's do it. Ah, fuck. I got to buy a PC. Fuck me.
Oh, wait. I don't have a computer. That's fucking hilarious.
Oh, no. What? I threw it across.
Where's the junk
that
wheel?
So hard it 10 feet past my dumpster.
What up, Firebird? Well, you want the drunk wheel tonight? Is that what you want, Firebird?
Ooh,
what's up, Firebird?
Whoa, Lord.
Wait, what's on the motherfucker first?
I know. I don't know.
Right now, it's probably still has Joe and Drew on it.
So. All
right.
Me and Joe.
Yeah.
And Drew.
Yeah. Well, like, you'd have to do a generic wheel with, like, 3, like, monumental things on there or something.
I think I'm just keeping it simple tonight, Firebird. $22.
That's what I think,
$22 and I'll do a shot, dude. $22, I'll do a shot.
Yeah, dude. I'm drinking, too, so you guys can fucking, like, kill us both or whatever.
Yeah. Tomorrow night.
I'm fucking Firebird smoking.
I don't know.
For donations. I'm just pouring.
And tomorrow night, DaVinci's crown is on the fucking line on Saturday night. Monetize this.
You become a shit bomb.
The Jack Daniels honey needs a return too.
Oh no, God no, fuck no.
I like that. I like
you
the
liked
honey.
It.
I like the honey. Yeah, I did. I really did
don't
like
waste
the honey.
Your money though,
honey
man.
Actually
that's
pretty good.
They put a shit
the best
ton of
honey
price on that though.
Was the Tennessee honey though?
What?
Tennessee honey.
You know what? It's better if you put honey from Tennessee. Your own area. Pop that right in the whiskey yourself.
Dunkachino, don't mind if I do.
What's my name?
Dunkachino.
Dunkachino. You want creamy goodness?
Dunkawino.
Say hello to my
don't dunk a weenie. They can't.
Well, no, it's for Pride.
Jesse, do you mind doing a huge bong rip live on the show? One that makes you cry in pain but fills you with love.
Who's gonna do a bong rip though? Who has a bong on them besides our guys?
I got a pipe.
I don't have a motherfucking. Dude, you know what I have though, and I will use it. I have a fucking pipe that is a big ass fish. Like
what?
No, seriously, you got to see this thing. You got it. Where the fuck is it? That thing is sick. Oh my god! Hang on, give me a moment. Give me a moment. I have to smoke out. I have to suck out of its mouth and smoke out of its belly. It's great. It is fantastic. If I can, where is it? It's got a really. Oh, there. No.
One time I went to a friend's house and they didn't have a pipe, so all they had was a novelty pipe, and it was a dick and balls. You had to smoke
nice.
That.
I would so. I'm down, dude. I'm gonna shit cradle the balls. The
I
balls are bubbling because it's a bong, you know. Okay, here we go. Got it.
See what I did to Garguts?
Fuck yeah.
I'm sorry, Garguts. Here's what.
So I can't do the bong rip. Gargoth, do you have a bong by chance on you?
Mm-mm.
All right, I was gonna say we'll do a double, but like whatever. I'll do the fish thing.
I'm gonna smoke blunts and my chillum.
Check this shit out, dude.
Smoke your asshole out.
Oh my god, that's great.
Wait, what'd you do to me?
That's actually badass.
Yeah, no, isn't it? So like fucking here's the where you load it up in the belly. The carb is on the tail. You suck out of the mouth like you're giving mouth to mouth to a pussy. And same deal. So I'll load this up and I'll go ahead and I'll do you one better and I'll throw some wax in the bowl. So here we go.
Nice.
Who the fuck was that anyway?
I shit on Gargoth the other night. Did you hear this, Jesse?
Oh, let me see.
Some people didn't hear this. Yeah. Listen to this. Ready? Here you go.
That was already loaded. You know, with whoever, whatever it was, you know? Because you could see the talent in people. And it's like, it's fun, man. You're like...
Oh, the fans didn't see
it. But recently, I just haven't been seeing as much of it around, you know? I just don't see it as much around, you know? And really, that's a shot at Gargoth. Let's be honest. I mean, that's a shot at Gargoth. You know, you put him on and he's like... Let me... One time, Chuck E. Cheese, I met Giddy Lee, and he was really cool. And then it's like, well, that wasn't a real story, so... And then we have to talk.
Oh, my God, dude. That is funny. You know, that makes... Like, that adds to the whole shit earlier. Oh, my God, that's
dude,
great.
That makes me die when I'm like... And that's... I mean, that's not a real story.
Hey, wait, Joe.
Look at that face.
The chat didn't get to see, they didn't get to see the fish. God damn it.
What fish?
The fish, the fucking, the thing they paid for to see me smoke out of.
Oh, let me get you on. Hold on.
You didn't see the fish pipe?
No, because it's on Gargoth. It's like frozen on Gargoth for some reason.
Hang on. Let me, put a light on and everything.
Let me put it on. Let me focus it on you. Hold on a minute. Let me focus it on you while I play
it's
this.
Already got weed in it. I'll go ahead and put.
All right. Now I got you on.
Like I said, I'll put
I focused it on you. I'll play the clip while you're smoking.
Recently, I just haven't been seeing as much of it around, you know? I just don't see it as much around, you know?
It's still not focusing yet.
And really, that's a shot at Gargoth. Let's be honest. I mean, that's a shot at Gargoth. You know, you put him on, and he's like, let me... One time, Chuck E. Cheese, I met Giddy Lee, and he's really cool. And then it's like, well, that wasn't a real story, so... And then we have to... It's awkward.
Here we go.
It's very awkward.
All right.
But
there you go, kiddos.
You know, you take what you have. The Discord's open. Anybody can call in. And an illegal Mexican liar is all we could get.
You become
an illegal Mexican liar is all we could get.
Your Gargoth sounds like a mixture of him and freaking your Ryback impression.
Yeah, and like, yes, that's true. It does kind of doesn't sound right.
Rogan.
And Rogan? Seth Rogen?
Seth Rogen. Yeah.
Oh, here we go.
Really? You think it sounds like... All right. Wow. I got more...
It sounds like Seth Rogen doing a Ryback impression.
I sound like a victim crying... Hey, go ahead.
They fry. Jews don't cry. They fry. Sorry.
Yes. Drew flies and cries. I agree.
Aw, Drew's a cheese. He's fish lips. Lesbian lips. We have
lesbian
to get
seagull.
Fish lips.
Happy Pride Month.
Same thing.
Doesn't it just fill you up with pride?
Hang on, I'll put some... This is older weed in here. I'll put some fresh in there. And then, dude, this thing's a pain in the ass because you can't put it upside down, and it's the only way you can set it down. And then the weed falls out, so I'm like, fuck.
And then the day
you sent it to me, and you said, oh, yeah, I shit on you. It's like 35 minutes into it. I fucking, like, played it over hip-hop, and I kept replaying it, just, like, little parts here and there.
Oh, my goodness.
That shit was fucking hilarious, but I didn't realize you kept going with it after that.
Some extra wax on the top as well.
Hey,
who donated? I don't remember.
Throw it off the top. Who gives a shit? Hey, throw him off the fucking building.
It was Furry Balls plopped menacingly on the table.
Oh, Mr. Balls. I got you. All right.
Mr. Balls.
You know what I got that from? When Alex Payne used to call Gargoth Mr. Guts. I'm like, I stole it. Fucking, you know, whatever. I stole it just like he. He sounds like he steals things, but then you find out he's white.
Yeah.
We don't do that.
Oh.
Well, I almost went backwards. This thing confuses me. All right, here we go.
What are you talking about?
I know plenty of meth heads that steal shit that are white.
Yeah.
Yeah, but I'm talking. Okay, well, not on the island.
Target.
Fuck that fucking thing.
Jellyman sang for a supper every night.
I just broke that lighter in pieces. I hope it doesn't spray gas.
Yo, you know what I've never seen in Mexico? All
right.
You know what I've never seen in America? A homeless Mexican.
Fuck
bullshit.
Off.
Really?
What the fuck are you talking about? Yeah. You've been to Home Depot?
You go to Skid Row.
What?
You'll see every color in 1,000 sleeping bags.
I swear, man. I don't know, man. Maybe on the East Coast is different, man. But all I ever see on the East Coast is, like,
white people.
Well, you got to understand, over here, dude, back when, like, Santa Monica and a few places, they, like, oh, no, when, what's his name? The dude that fell ran into a tree, Sherry's husband.
Sonny Bono.
All the homeless people. But, yeah, when he was mayor, he told all the homeless people, come on over. And so we have a shit ton and of every color, every sleeping bag you can imagine. No food. Yeah. But, you know, you'll be chilling in like, Santa Monica, like, looking, like, hey, baby, look at the, like, we're looking at the water. And all of a sudden, whatever, dude, comes up to you, and he's digging out of the trash can next to you, just like, how you doing? And he's ripping shit out. He's looking for cans or whatever he's trying to get. And there's nobody, like, there could be 25 of them there. It doesn't matter. Like, they were told, you can come and live. Like, it doesn't matter if you want to sleep on the grass in the park or... Oh, that's why he ran into a tree.
Oh.
Anyway.
Damn.
I was going to say, Ben's
feet. Do you believe in life after death? Sorry.
You're cool.
Well, you mentioned homeless, and so let's go ahead and take a look right now.
Sorry, it's not a bong, but that'll have to do.
Yeah, Venice Beach is like your big
It's
one.
Time once again on the Joe Cronin
I
Show
love Venice.
To take a look at Venice Beach and to see the homeless people. It's time once again. It's a segment
it's
we call
actually not as bad there.
We love the homeless. Here on the Joe Cronin Show.
I love that. Oh, you're a smarty, Greg. Your name's really Greg.
This is right. On the Joe Cronin Show, we always spend a segment talking about the homeless in Venice. So let's get down with
Do
them right now.
Do they skateboard or like, I mean, because everybody skateboards in Venice, even the homeless.
Oh, of course. Well, here they are, everybody. Let's
no
take
home,
a look.
But I got a fucking wicked ollie. Look at me.
No homo. There they are, everybody. Yes, what's going on? How's all my parrot heads? A new song by Jimmy Buffett.
Oh, my God. Oh no.
I don't feed the homeless. Look at all you homeless fucks sitting in the dark.
Oh,
look at you looking out and trying to take a shit tonight. You're sleeping in shit, you're leaving shit, there ain't nowhere in shit. But sure as shit, you're gonna sit in shit because you're just shit. Your life is shit.
This is a song's fucking monologue.
Oh my
I'm
God.
Sorry.
With the video he's showing, this is ridiculously funny.
The slow panning of the camera.
I guess I should have never voted for that liberal, but I did.
Oh yeah.
Black living in shit. White living in shit. Hispanics living in shit. Mexicans living in shit. White
same
people
thing.
Living in shit. Black people and white people living together in shit. Is that a black guy dead in the street or a pile of fucking shit? Oh my God, there's shit everywhere. White people too. Every single way you look, it's a human fucking zoo. Whites are homeless. Whites are homeless. So many white homeless people. So many white people.
You can get AIDS from a napkin out here.
Shitting in the street.
What did it just? It literally just turned into Rapper's Delight from fucking Jimmy Buffett.
Oh, good shit.
Damn it. What? The sugar hell fucking homeless gang.
Listen.
Dude, when the camera's slowly panning over the tents and shit.
Yes, right? Yes. That is the money shot.
Oh my God.
No, that's what made it so much better. Like, I was already digging what you were doing, but then when it came on the screen, and I was like, oh my God.
I was like,
this is We Are the World, but backwards. Like, we are the AIDS.
All the white people, everyone, all the races living together in shit. It's amazing. California.
Dude, it's diversity. It's unison.
We are the lost.
Oh, let's pull so that song out.
So basically, we love homeless people. Then
you know what's funny though, dude? When I mean, like, same dude that I've talked about before, who has like he's one of the literally one of the only survivors left of the original AIDS, HIV. Like he said, like he felt freer and safer on Skid Row than he does anywhere. Like than he really does
not
now.
Because not anymore.
No, no, I don't know actually how it is now, but like. It's like you really didn't, you did have like people sticking up for you. Like you had a family, you had a community. And if somebody tried to come and fuck all of that up, you weren't alone. Like, and
that's
it didn't
a good
matter
point.
If you had nothing, you didn't have two nickels to rub together, but you had peace of mind and you had peace and you had family. And it was like, wow, I learned a lot from this dude. Still do.
Yeah.
But yeah, it's amazing, dude, because you really do take a look. Makes you step back a second and go, what the fuck am I complaining about? Even if you have a lot to fucking complain about, it's justified. You still, it's nice to hear a story that somebody tells you or something that's like, god damn, whoa. Like you all of a sudden you have no problems in the world because you realize like, wow. Like I love that shit. Do we all need to be humbled now and again? Shit, yeah.
Oh,
bunch of white people, privileged motherfucker.
All the white dead people, the homeless dead people everywhere. White people.
Oh my god! Can we have we need a wrestler, one wrestler to come out like on mainstream, and he's called Privilege.
Oh my
god! He's whiter than shit. He's whiter than Sheamus, and
that's hard.
That would be amazing, dude. Coming down the aisle.
That's
cool.
Raping a girl behind the dumpster.
Right.
He's got them all, and I'll tell you what, Magaluf handed to him.
Look at them all. Look at them all. Look at them.
The nation. In the eyes
domination.
Of homeless.
No.
In the world of homeless people.
These people are happier than you are.
There are people living in shit. They're all living in shit. Together, black, white, or yellow. We can't go on pretending day by day that somewhere someone can make a change.
There you go.
We all deserve to live in houses with our loved ones, but instead we're living on Venice Beach. Smelling of fecal matter, we are the dead. We are the homeless. We are the ones who live in shit every day. I'll show you. And there's some shit right next to me. We're living in shit every day. And even though I'm living in shit, I say,
aww.
Send me your shit. I took all the shit and put it on my eBay. Imagine like they're like it's becoming so famous, all the homeless shit in California, that some of the people are actually like taking the shit and putting it into jars and selling it on eBay. It's a great idea. What?
It's art.
God no.
They'll art, do it.
It's art.
It's
sell
art.
Your aborted art. Juices.
It's matter
you
of
sell that.
Fart matter.
It's oh,
come on.
Wait, now that you told me that, I mean, I'm on. How much?
Oh, I mean, $15.99. You know?
Can I do the four payment plan PayPal thing? I'm on board.
We live in shit. We live in feces. We live in piss. We live in poo. So we got diabetes. We go to bed every night smelling all the dung. And poop is in front of my mom. Okay. Enough of this.
Joe, that was
dude,
great.
I just randomly reached for whatever fucking scale harmonica I had. I got like 12 different
oh
scales.
My
I'm
God,
like, I
this
one will do. And I'm like... Dude, it worked one night. I don't remember what song we did, but like I pulled out the G one and I was like, and it went so good. God damn it, that was fun. I don't know what it was. Well, was it a Tommy song?
I don't remember now. I don't remember.
It was like 2 months ago.
Do a solo.
I don't know.
Dude, you should go fuck yourself. Drums.
What?
And fucking play along to that. I say you should bust out your drums and play it along to that.
Dude, I will fucking kill every last one of you if you pull an instrument out.
Hey.
Oh, yeah. Remember when Jesse used to just play guitars on the show and I used to look at him like, I'm going to kill you?
I used to not. I was trying to do it like off on the side. Dude, we had all hitters at the time. It was like, yeah. Well, I don't have to talk here. I'll just kind of, you know.
No, it was still, but normally, like what we should have done was a hangout stream where we all did just chill and do nothing. Like, it didn't matter if you did that.
Oh, that would have been sick if we had, like, because we had that once in a while, but we really were, like, in show mode. So, yeah, right. That would have been cool.
That's what it was. We were, like, into bits, and you were
maybe
like,
maybe JB will come back for that. Tell him, look, we're just going to hang out, jerk off.
Well,
you can come over.
You'd have to tell him. I don't know.
Dude, that might be the key. I'm not even fucking with you. That used to
be the
key.
No, the key is me dead. That's the key. Me dead.
No, it's not. No, you're so full of shit. Can I just tell you that right now? That is such bullshit.
I think you would come back if I was dead.
It's not always that somebody hates you.
I don't think.
I don't think. Why it is?
Well, I'm not saying that. I just said I didn't say that. I said I think he'd come back if I was
dead.
What
does he want you dead mean? He loves you.
No, I don't think he wants. No, he doesn't want me dead. I'm just saying I think he would come back if I was dead. Like Leo was doing a memorial show or something. Like just want to say bye to everybody.
Oh wow, you don't. Oh my God, it's gonna take more than that, or less than that, less than that. More than that, Jesus Christ, that's gonna be a lot, wouldn't it? No,
I'm just kidding.
Dude, he wants to come back. I can guarantee you.
Oh, fuck yourself.
No, he does.
Fuck off.
He just doesn't know it.
Yeah, like my wife wants to come back on my Facebook page. Get out of here.
Whoa, hey, good luck. I mean, dude, we are both so fucked up. That sucks. I'm already thinking of my own shit. I'm like, yeah.
I might be in that same realm too. So.
Oh, what'd you do, Gargus?
Oh.
What'd
dude,
you
no
do,
worries.
Gargus?
It'll be all right.
I don't do nothing. That's what it is.
Dude, she beat the shit out of you with goggles on. Like,
I'm gonna get the shit beaten out of me.
Oh shit!
Wait, you had the
shit. That's allegedly, but like, I just saw it in her personality. That's not something I saw.
No, we all good. I just went to go hang out earlier.
I think Luis died a while ago. I don't know.
I was confused on your. When you were talking about going to Vegas and shit, and the way you were talking about like escorts and shit, I'm like, you still with your girl?
I'm allowed to do whatever.
See? I like that. I was kind of in that same realm, except not really.
But
it was a little confusing.
Yeah, it was confusing at first, but you know,
It always is. You have to be fully on or off with that.
What did you do, Gargus?
Nothing.
Woo!
It's just
he fucked Alex Radford in the ass.
No.
Fight.
No, I went to go hang out today. We're
oh boy.
But I'm saying like yeah, it's being it's
make
probably because I'm not a social media person, so I just don't ever give a shit.
Oh yeah, yeah. I probably will be homeless at some point, you know, and I'll be like that guy in the trash pit.
No, you won't.
Well, Jesse, think about how funny it's going to be, like, someday. Like, seriously, like, I mean, like, the kids will go with, like, Leah and her parents or something like that. But I'll be homeless, and I'll be, like, laying there, and I'll just start cracking up.
We'll be together.
Maybe, Jesse.
Dude, if you find the clip. No, you said this in 6 months of me being around. You said this way back when, like, Tommy and Dave were here. Maybe Tommy and Chris. And it was like you played the Forrest Gump music or whatever, and you went, you know, it's going to be fucking someday. It's just going to be Leah's going to die. And like, and all you had was Gavin at the time, keep in mind. And you go, you know, Gavin turns gay, and so he turns on me. And it's just you and me, Jesse. We're jerking each other off in the end. And it's like you went on this shit, and it was playing that sad fucking... I don't know if it's in the credits or whatever, Forrest Gump shit.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, dude, it was amazing. So you're basically telling me that now. You're going to be homeless.
I'm saying, do you know how
I'm
funny...
Good. I own the property.
Do you know how funny it will be when I'm, like, homeless and I'm, like, and I remember making this joke and I'll be, like, and I'll just start laughing hysterically. You know what I mean? I'll be, like...
That is how you embrace madness, by the way, when you realize everything you do. You just start laughing and you can't even cry. Like, tears are coming, but you're Joker laughing. Not fakely like Tommy, but really Joker laughing.
100%. I'm telling you.
A pound of money.
This fat up shit.
I'm telling you. It will happen to me. It's.
Well, you have to break. Like, that's the literal breaking that people talk about.
but he loves his son. Psycho Dad. Killed his wife because he ran out of
time. Oh my.
Whitman remembers. Holy shit. Who's the man when you hit
your gun? What the fuck?
He kills for fun. Psycho Dad. Psycho Dad. It's been our theme song all night on the show tonight. Psycho Dad. It's unbelievable. Thanks to everybody for all the donos, including D. Welsh earlier, who really rocked us. Thank you for that. And we're a couple more things, and we'll be on the way to monetize this tomorrow night. And do we ever, Luis, are you alive? Alejandro, you
yes,
okay?
Sure.
I'm fucking my corpse.
He has been dead silent for this whole, like, for a while. He's been
dead
silent.
That's what jerking off does, man.
Well, there he is. He's
Luis. Oh, wait, did he? Wait a minute. Did he just say what I said he was going to say? What'd you say, Luis?
What? What did he say?
I was working on something.
Oh, I thought.
Are you working off?
I said he's going to come on and be like, I was muted the whole time. That's what I thought he was going to come back and say.
I'm working on jerking on.
What are you working on? Like your next, like a bomb to take out the Republicans?
No, he's getting the coordinates to the, you know, the Google Maps of the next binoculars.
You
know,
on the plane.
In China,
he was the one on the plane.
In China,
you fucking in, least don't be mad.
In China, it's called. Sorry.
Oh no! Yes, they have to zoom in because they can barely see as it is.
I'm sorry, I had to clip that.
Like I told Edgeview, I said you're a great wrench guy for someone who doesn't have their eyes open.
Ooh.
No,
well, oh.
The thing is that they close their eyes to snipe in on them.
You're a racist. Like all those guys
That's
out.
That's true. No, I'm not a racist. Like, I'm a realist.
Like all those
Don't
white.
Fuck with me.
All those white people who keep knocking out the Asian people. Or I guess they're not white.
I love Asian people. I lived with them and bought weed off them in high school.
Wait.
Hey.
Yeah, but
Asian
you didn't hear about the Asian. You didn't
I was
hear
protected
about
by them. They were some heavy gangs, dude. They
you
were great.
Asian. You didn't
I
hear about the Asian
goops.
Guy that fucking killed those two black dudes. Because that never
I don't give a shit.
The
they were good to me. Gooks were good
about
to
the
me.
Kids? Why he killed
good,
kids?
No, what about kids, man?
No, I said a fucking Asian guy killed two black guys, and nobody here talks about that.
I thought it was two kids.
Who cares?
Was it two kids?
It's not a white guy. You know? Wait, no, nobody cares if an Asian kills
that.
Anybody. It's
yeah,
a,
he got
if,
off.
If the black
got
guys,
off.
If the black guys killed the Asian, then they'd care. Because it's Asian hate. Hey,
got
it's
off.
Fucking COVID.
Right? Right? Yesterday about killing Asians?
Yeah, but since an Asian killed two black people,
that's the new trend, apparently. When the fucking history has a fucking suicide bomber been called an Asian? Never. And now it is so that we can say, oh, there's more Asian hate. No.
Fuck are you talking
right.
about? Technically, if you're
my
from the
point
middle,
is recently they have been putting shit on the Asian hate that are people that we would have never even looked at twice, except hey, you getting on this airplane? You got a ticket or what? Like you know, like that's it. Like they're cool little Muslim.
No,
people,
in the '90s there was a whole
no.
Asian...
Nobody called it Asian hate. That's my point. Now it's
no,
Asian
they did. They
hate.
Called it. They called it
I mean,
hate crimes back then, and they would
well,
go against Asians.
Nah, Asian. Fuck that. No,
that
but this is, this is different. This is where I'm saying they're like you know, the Oriental term, like that. They are deciding where to like laser scope that shit in, and say this is Asian hate. They never have done it like this before. This is a new.
Oh, I thought you meant.
Play.
Like, oh, okay. I thought you meant the other way around. Okay, I got you.
I don't the other way around I think's been done or no the other way happened too what you said but that was more like America fucking don't blow up my fucking trade center you know that shit like the other you know other than that I mean nobody thought of people okay nobody thought of the people that blew into buildings and shit as Asians nobody said that and that was not what was propagated for sure or like fucking perpetuated now it is, and what it makes you go like, well, what the fuck you? Like they make you know where I go twice a week for food?
No,
the Gook Spoon down the road. You get Whoa, you a fucking. Restaurant? They don't even use chopsticks. You could spoon up fucking noodles. It's a weird place. I don't know how they
and
do it.
Chicken.
It's like a curly noodles. Straw Nesquik thing. It's weird.
Yeah, so you get the chitty chicken from the chitty wok. I got you.
Dude, you had no what Chitty was walk. Your gimmick? Oh, what was the store Gargant that you wanted to open?
Fuck.
Oh, you don't remember, whoa, you fucking stoner. God damn it, was fucking it was wiggle licking good, the chicken.
Oh,
remember?
Yes. God damn. Yeah. Oh my god.
Oh my god, it was so good, dude. Oh god damn
you.
We had
a whole slogan for it and everything.
I know that. I just said the slogan.
I
hope people enjoyed that because he won't remember.
Fuck. I was like, it's gonna serve you chicken and 40s. Or something like that.
I don't even remember that. I just remember the name was so good. Oh, you
chicken
cunt.
40s. God.
Dude, wait, it was 40s fucking... Oh, dude, it was Humberwoman Chicken or some shit.
I don't remember. Damn, that was.
Dude, you suck. This is what happens with 11-hour streams. You know, 11-hour streams, you forget shit.
Well, I gotta rewatch them. Oh, it is.
Yeah, I know. That's our fault. That's your fault, actually. I don't rewatch shit, and I shouldn't. I've been here 8 years. I used to rewatch shit when I was insecure and was looking for spots, but now I don't give a fuck. I just fucking, if I watch it, it's because I'm watching it. Otherwise, I don't give a shit what I said. It's a show. Shut up. You know what I mean? So, but you should be watching, motherfucker, because you're Mexican and you're new.
Oh.
Not new, but, you know, new.
I'm new blood.
Yeah, whitey.
No, you're fucking more old school than most people, but you're, like, no, but I mean, like, girl. Dude, you should watch your own shows, though, because God damn it, that was funny. You should be time stamping. Rapey Viper. Rapey. Do you have this time stamp? No. He's in the next room. Look at me.
I think Getty's got it. Getty's on top of it.
What?
And
no
Coda.
Shit.
Coda will fucking be. But fucking nobody clips it more than.
You're putting a lot of hope into three different people here.
Well, Gardner's clip shit more than
you, so if it wasn't funny.
Drew would not even. Drew's gonna clip shit that burns us all to hell.
Oh, that's
well, Gargots can't be racist because everyone mistakes him for being different races all the time.
What do they
no
say?
Way
he
is? He's racist.
He ain't gonna clip nothing. Mean, that guy
well,
can't.
You call, you,
wait, what other races?
You are call? You said he's dark.
Dude,
like
oh. I could be Mexican,
he's not a
Asian. Jackie. I could be Mexican, Filipino, and Indian on the same
bullshit.
Day.
I don't know.
What are you, Elizabeth Warren?
Indian. You are not Filipino.
What
that.
Did you say? Joe, what
Elizabeth
the fuck?
Warren. He thinks he's Elizabeth Warren. Or no, he thinks he's like in Kamala.
Oh, no.
Kamala Harris does that too. Whatever Kamala's doing, like she's like, oh, now I can be that.
She's black or Jamaican.
Or
the
Indian.
First one you said,
oh,
Joe, the
God,
fucking
yeah.
other bitch. That
oh
fucking
God.
Gold. Oh my God!
Yeah, didn't she come out like a Native American?
Yeah,
Oh my God!
Oh God, I'm gonna explode!
Do not come,
dude. Chino looks
fucking
serious.
Oh, I don't think I can hold it.
Do not come.
I gotta come. I gotta.
Do not come.
We did it.
Wow. I love that one.
Actually, I'm actually working on drawing a Ryback right now. I don't know. I was hoping to give it a as a donation.
What?
I'm doing a drawing of Ryback. I was wondering if you would like to use it as your donation. Like I mean,
you're doing a what a Ryback?
Okay. Do you have something that you can send to Joe that he can listen to?
Oh, no, it's just a drawing, but I can like get a picture of it and have it sent to him.
Oh. Okay.
Oh, so. I get it. Yeah, I wish we could get a cameo.
I thought you had like a song or something.
Oh no, just the drawing. My bad.
That's cool though. Like it could be used. Fucking hey, if it just send
yeah,
it. Man.
I could probably put like yeah, like on both sides of the.
Do people send this shit to Ryback? Like I've never really. I don't have Twitter.
Lots of people.
Oh God damn it! I love that. Do it even more.
Hilarious.
Just fuck with that guy.
Next time you meet
Ryback,
I guarantee that's going to be even more controversy.
Oh, yeah. You know it. Listen, we got to get
out
of here.
You
got to
like start off. Turn him off. Like first, like get on his good side. Go. I love when you ate like five things of like hot noodles. Do you think you could take five hot dicks? you start off like stroking his ego, and then you ram him, dude. Just. I would fuck you in your singlet, you little cuckold.
Oh, my God,
Oh, my God. Curting.
Jesse's on fire. I love it.
He's going to respond to somebody if they all went in hard like that. Oh, he deserves it, too. He's a fucking bully.
He is a bully.
I'm a bully.
He's a fucking bully.
To bullies.
Or he's insecure. He's an insecure. I don't even know if he's that much of a bully, but he's an insecure as shit.
Not even Paul Heyman has
a lot of things.
And I don't, you know. He shouldn't be though. Dude, that guy got his sweat on me at a fucking house show. It was him versus CM. No, what happened? All right, it was him and CM Punk, right? And then like it's the end. CM Punk runs away, whatever DQ. He comes around, he's like, yeah, fucking slapping me. And I was like, why don't you put my fist out? He slams my fist with his and he's going all over him. Dude, he was sweating like a son of a bitch. But like I will say, 2012.
Doesn't it just feel 13.
Maybe 13. Maybe 13. Yeah. That was actually before SummerSlam 2013 when I went. So yeah. It was, dude, SmackDown, this house shows were better than anything else on TV. Like the house shows I went to were sick. SummerSlam 2012, Blue Balls.
They were all kind of like.
It was shit. House shows were great. You had I Quit matches. You had title exchanges. You had all kinds of shit go down. Money in the Bank came out.
They were all like
just. Fuck? I had a whole pay per view
for what's gonna happen.
Pretty much.
Yeah, I dug it, dude. I got a great show for it. I was front row too.
When I went to a house show, it was Kane versus Daniel Bryan, and I pretty much saw what they were planning out for fucking Extreme Rules without the fucking Extreme Rules.
Wow, that's a trend. Dude, you know what's weird? I go into a Raw and a fucking SmackDown both, and I never saw either one of those guys. I saw John Cena and Dolph Ziggler, saw CM Punk, Ryback. I never saw a Daniel Bryan and Kane until I went to SummerSlam 13. That's weird. They weren't on the house shows. What the fuck? Or they weren't on all of them.
Well, I believe it's Texas because Daniel Bryan trained down here at Shawn Michaels' school forever.
Oh, okay. Then, Shawn Michaels, right?
Yeah. So then, of course, Kane's going to be down here, too. I mean, they were doing a program.
I think I went to Staples and I went to Arrowhead Pond. I went to those two places.
I smell you.
Gargi.
Can't believe they weren't on the house shows. I mean, the fact I was watching John Cena and like other people, I was like, no shit. Shield wasn't there either because they were doing a taping for it was on a Tuesday, so
right,
Raw, you know. Jesse. I got to see Big E though, I guess so. He was there, but no Shield.
Jesse,
yeah,
Jesus Cunt. Christ, is that abuelita?
What up, dude? What up, my grandmother? What's up, homie? Esk, what
as in the Arrowhead Pond.
Yes, the Arrowhead Pond, Anaheim, where Gold Dust and fucking goddamn Alita Bologna, that Roddy Piper.
Roddy Piper.
What about it, dude? What about it? Did you fucking pick up a hot floozy there or what? Hot piece of ass?
Did you get fucked in the ass in the bathroom?
Oh.
Yeah, okay, you can talk now. Come on, Loudy.
I've only been to the Staples Center like about 5 times.
Sure.
The Arrowhead Pond / Honda Center.
I recommend going to the Arrowhead Pond. Here's why. Because bathrooms, and when you're walking through to get your stuff, you remember Stone Cold getting beaten up at Royal Rumble 99, and he was right there, wherever you're at.
Oh.
It was kind of cool. And also, like, where you cut, like, just everything. Like, where the cars come in, you drive on the same spot that Gold Dust and Roddy Piper fucking went through in the Bronco, with all that shit, the gold car, the Bronco. You are there amongst all of shit, and right. It's amazing to go to the Arrowhead Pond for that. I would say.
Do you remember being raped? Personally. Do you remember that?
Yes,
Luis.
Some guy with a bloody nose. I don't know why it was blue, but he was a mean dude.
That
was the Maiden concert,
Luis. Whoops, Luis. That's the same arena. That's the same arena that Terry Reynolds got fucked. By a new jet with a knife.
Oh my god.
ECW played over there?
History. Just like this. I went to the Raw on November 5th.
What year?
Later, Miley Cyrus was going to have a concert there.
Oh god. What fucking year?
What year?
Luis, what year?
2007.
Hey,
you say that. It's so long.
Cunt fucking nugget.
2009, I went to both ECW and SmackDown because remember that the Nuggets.
Oh my god.
What the fuck, dude? Why do I not have the fucking... All right, I got to start listening to myself on some other purpose. Tonight has been psychically hilarious. Jesus.
The next time I went you too, was... Joe.
Oh.
When I started fucking working here at LA Pump.
Oh my, don't dock your fucking self. Fucking pump and dump?
At the pump and dump?
You're going to get fired now, you know.
LA Dump.
Now an alien's going to get you fired.
At the LA Dump.
Don't mention where you work. Say it's Wendy's. That's where we all work. Tommy started it.
I'm not going to get fired.
All right, you better tell them. All right, well, okay.
We're really good at fucking pumping them. Pumps and shit.
That's where we all were.
Hey, I'm gonna love head a guy out, that guys.
Gets him an escort. All right, see you tomorrow.
I went to 2013. That's right.
See you tomorrow night.
You were there where I was, dude. I was there too. You didn't come say hi. You piece of shit.
Yeah, I'll see you tomorrow, Joe. Hopefully,
love you, brother.
Yep. Good night, Jesse. Good night, guys.
Oh.
Hang on, dude. I never knew
you.
That.
She's looking over you ominously. She's like, oh no, it's time.
Dude, no, you better go get some, dude.
It's time to fuck.
No, I did tell her. Tell her Jesse sent you or some shit.
It's time for round two.
Finisher.
It's time for round two.
Cody, we're going to do this. I'm still ready for that tag team, Cody. So high five for
that. Wait, dude, I didn't know, Luis, you were at the same SummerSlam. You piece of shit.
You were at the SummerSlam, Cody.
No, I was
like
2013.
Section 3 something. I don't
remember. I don't give a shit, dude. I don't remember a section. I ain't a loser. I fucking remember. No.
Hey, Cody.
Dude, that's cool, though, man. I love that. So you've been here that long? I didn't know you from the beginning. Or were you? Were you? Like, when did you find Joe?
Yeah, he's been, Luis, a while.
19? Wow, okay. You've been here from the get-go. Okay.
Wait, what did you say, 19?
He said 19.
Wait, is that what he said? 19. Oh, I thought it said 13.
I also went to...
No, that's cool, though.
I went to Raw.
Yeah.
A couple years ago when Dean Ambrose was still in the company.
Yeah. Dude, I couldn't afford that. Like, I was doing, like, $500 a ticket to get front row, but it was at house shows, and I'm like, well, I'll take front row. And I was actually better off because I didn't have any commercials. It was 3.5 hours. And I got more of a show than I saw on TV. So I was like, all right.
Got it cheaper outside of the fucking stadium on the day.
No, no, dude. Fuck those people. I needed the right tickets in the right place. And I don't know.
Failed me, bro.
I overpay. I went
for
to
like
scout.
$50 and I got a fucking amazing seat.
Oh, really?
Well, dude, it happens. I got $55 for two tickets to see Judas Priest like 15 rows back. I was in the handicap.
Damn.
Like, it happens. But other than that, like, scalpers are fucking. Man,
I don't know. The scalpers in the ass. We got to get out of here, guys.
Tell
I'll
me
see
some
you.
Skin. I don't want a t-shirt.
Have fun, man. Continue it. Let the good times roll.
Yeah, whatever you got to do, man.
I'll be back tomorrow. Monetize this. Start to 10 tomorrow night. I'm sure
MGM
I might be
Eastern.
I might be doing something in the day, but probably definitely monetize this tomorrow night, 10 p.m. And what's his face? Davicius.
Yeah.
Puts his crown on the line.
So you're gonna be on Joe Cronin show, right?
Yes.
That's the one. All right, there you go. 10 p.m. Eastern.
It's got to be.
Come get fucked up and let's regret the rest of your lives tomorrow night.
Tomorrow night, we expose Drew's wife.
That means crazy shit goes down.
We expose Drew's wife, Tara's nudes. Tomorrow night on Monetize This.
Great. And, he's coming back in a week to talk about it.
Oh, yeah. He's going to.
A whole lot of woman.
Whoa! A whole lot of woman. Oh, my God. That's so funny. What the fuck? Oh, my God, dude. Wow. That's a whole lot of woman. And we're going to end the show tonight with another classic performance by the one and the only. You know him, Jimmy Buffett. Let's go to the tape now. Good night, everybody. We'll see you tomorrow night for Monetize This, starting at 10 p.m. or ish time tomorrow night. And you all have a good night. Take it away, the final song or another song from Jimmy Buffett. I can't believe we have all these great ones. And you all have a good night. We have great to see you guys tonight. Let's go to the concert. They're lively over there. I know all my parrot heads out there love this song. And I know you all are going to love this song here tonight. Mother, Mother Ocean.
I have heard you call, I hear you calling. Wanted to sail upon your waters since I was 3 feet tall. You've seen it all. Yes, you have. You've seen it all. I love you. Watch the man who rode you switch from sail to steam. In your belly, you hold treasures you have ever seen. Most of them dream. Most of them dream. I love you all. Yes, I am a pirate. 200 years too late. Cannons don't thunder. There's nothing to plunder. I'm over 40, victim of fate. At least I'm not homeless like all those California cocksuckers. I've done a bit of smuggling. I've run my share of grass. Fuck the homeless. I made enough money to buy Miami, but I pissed it away so fast. Never meant to last. But at least I didn't become homeless. Never meant to last. Drunk now for over 2 weeks. I passed out in a rally in a fun few weeks. But I gotta stop wishing. I gotta go fishing. I'm down to rock bottom again. Just a few friends. Just a few friends. You're all my friends. All my parrot heads are my friends. You guys are my friends and none of us are homeless. I go for younger women. I live with seven a while. Oh, I ran them away. They come back one day. Still couldn't manage a smile. It takes a while. It just takes a while. It takes a while to rape them. Mother Ocean, after all the years I've found, occupational hazard be occupation just not around. I feel like I drown. I'm gonna head out of town, everybody. Good night. I'm gonna head out of town. Thanks, Jimmy Buffett, for sending us home another night. I can't believe he would say fuck the homeless. That was terrible. But, you know, Jimmy Buffett is, you know, never been the biggest, never been a big country fan myself. In fact, I think I like more rap than country, but I do like Jimmy Buffett, but I just can't condone that stuff he said about homeless people. Just terrible. Terrible stuff. I can't believe Jimmy Buffett said that. Oh, well. Good night. Shout out to D. Welsh for the Hundy Bomb.
Wait a second, I got a big breaking news story. I gotta tell you something. Would you all say you want more Buffett? Is that what you said? Oh, I don't believe it. Really do appreciate the fact you're sitting here. Your voice sounds loud, wonderful, but your face don't look so clear. So barmaid, bring a pitcher, another round of brew. Honey, why don't we get drunk
and screw. Yeah, we're back, folks. Why don't we get drunk and screw? Why don't we all screw? I just bought a water bed. Fill it up for me and you. You are a snuff queen. Honey, I don't think that's true. You know what I want to do? I want to get drunk and screw. Oh, I see a lot of people in this crowd tonight, and I think you all want to. You want to screw, don't you? I'll screw all of you and your kids. Or your wives, Jimmy Buffett. Let's make it happen, folks. Why don't we get drunk and screw? I just bought a water bed filled up for me and you. They say you are a snuff wing. Honey, I don't think that's true. So why don't we get drunk and screw? I bought a gun and I'm gonna kill all of you. Good night. Desecrate you. You let me penetrate you. You let me complicate you. Homeless, I broke apart my own home. Help. Homeless, is that shit I smell? Outside.
Venice, and in California, so liberal, but we are so homeless, I can smell the stench from downtown. Los Angeles, San Diego, San Francisco, and Chinatown. Venice Beach, homeless Venice Beach.
Oh my god. Oh my god. What a mess.
If you're going to San Francisco, be sure to wear a diaper, 'cause there's shit all over the place. If you're going to San Francisco, you're gonna meet a lot of homeless people there, and genitals and ball sack hair. For those who come to San Francisco, fecal matter all over the floor. There's lots of shit, there's lots of piss, and there's lots of the homeless. Gentle in San Francisco, all across the nation, they're coming here and shitting in our streets. People taking shits, people taking shits in the streets, people living in their tents. It smells like shit. It looks like shit. It's literal shit. It's literal shit. Oh, for those who come to San Francisco, you're gonna see a lot of shit in the street and Ann fucking Tifa. It used to be so beautiful. San Francisco. Now it looks like shit everywhere that you go in San Francisco. If you come to San Francisco, summertime smells like homeless fecal matter.